Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Greenhouse Lounge. Bear Farmer 73 here. Sorry it took me so long, y'all. I had to go wash up a little bit. Look, I got on a loose meat sandwich shirt and everything. I had to go wash up. Because between my allergies, if y'all hear me sound stopped up, it's that time of year. And I had to go wash all that pollen off of me from cutting the grass and planting banana trees and everything else. Okay, tonight I'm going to be answering some questions that I've been getting here for the last couple days. And hey, Green Organic Love. Hey, Miss G. Mama, daughter, sister in the house, how you doing? I'm going to be answering. Whoa, there we go. Tammy W, how you doing today? Rosette Soil and Seed said I got my seeds yesterday. Doris, how do you slow this down? Nene M, how you doing? Y'all, excuse me for sounding stuffed up. Pollen got me. Yeah, the virus ain't bit me. I'm just stuffed up. Tamika Finch, Maureen Chavis say hello everyone. Like, whoa, that's flying. Hey, Greg Adams, say, hey, what's going on, man? Good to see you. Sweet. Hey, what I do with them glasses? Damn, my work shirt. Hey, Suzanne Mukes, how you doing tonight? Valerie Williams, Yeri Ya, how you doing tonight? Let me see if them will work for me. I'll be down.
Why you gotta look like that? What's wrong with your face? Just cause you put them
on. I don't know, I feel like when you put them on, you put them through like this.
Why you gotta
what you
that?
Doing here?
Why you
doing? I don't know. They just make me feel like a grandpa.
Just put them on your face.
I am. But you can't help it when you put the reed glasses on. You do.
They scratched up. You're not gonna be able to get that out.
Well, you automatically do the long lip like.
Nah.
I told y'all I'm being here by 12:00. I can't help it. Okay. I can see better though. Doing all. Hey, Greg Adams. Michelle Osborne. Sacred, but the thing moving so fast. I can't help
you don't
it.
Gotta do your face. It's progressive, so you don't even gotta do that.
Is DJ? Y'all give me a second.
Yeah,
get the coal up. What now?
You don't even gotta do that. They progressive, so as you look up, ain't no prescription up there. So you don't gotta do that. You just like doing it.
Okay.
Okay, never mind.
So I don't gotta put them down like this.
No.
Everybody say, hey, babe. Hey, oh my God.
Hey,
Pamela.
Y'all.
Pamela Gins, ER Joe. Two backs in the pack in the house said, thanks, Lady Lynn, for accepting me into your group. Oh my God, this thing is moving so fast. I can't keep up with it. I'm going to try this. That's moving even faster. Let me see. Tracy Glenn, GT Grossit. Hey, what's going on? Miss Destiny, I always mess that first word up. Nelly Vasquez, Jack Hill Hall, what is that? Condon Cooking Mama's Homestead. I can hardly read that. That was a lot of words. Blissful Savings. Look. Nate M. R.V. Gardner. R.V. Gardner, how you doing tonight? I ain't see you in a minute. I've been looking all over for you. Frank Flytrap. Frankie, what's going on, man? Valencia Jones, whoa, Nelly Vasquez, Carolina's Best, how you doing tonight? Perry Herman, you sure these do? Two Max in a pack, NJ Cali Gardner, how you doing, young man? Mary Cleveland, Patience White, Miss Tasha Mack, whoa, how do you slow it down? Bees, I'm ready to learn. Everybody, I'ma do this. And I'm going to let y'all go at it because the screen moving so fast, I can't keep up with it. I want you. You already know what I'm going to say. I want you to represent your. Let me stop throwing up signs. I want you to represent your city, your state, your grow zone, and show love for where you from so everybody else in the room knows exactly where you from. I am Lev Farmer 73. That was Grandpa Land Farmer 73. I'm Land Farmer 73. I'm in Columbia, South Carolina. I'm in Grow Zone 8A. Where are you from? Represent your city, your state, and your grow zone. If you do not know your grow zone, get off right now. Go Google your zip code and ask Google, what is your zip? What is your grow zone? It'll tell you. Then come back and represent your city and your state. So far, I see Goldsboro, North Carolina. Oh, remember her granny. Her granny is from Goldsboro, North Carolina.
Who is?
The name is her granny.
Oh, okay.
Goldsboro is a small town, her granny. We might be some family. Let me see. Google says 5B. Oya, 5B shows me state Missouri. Grows on 7A. I'm going to keep going. Colorado Springs. This screen is zooming. Atlanta, Georgia. I can't keep up. Y'all know I can't keep up with that. Represent your city and your state and your grow zone. Keep that rolling. Keep that moving. Let people know, look, you where you are because you like it. And if you ain't, you know you about to move somewhere else. But for now, represent your city, your state, and your grow zone. Show some love for your where you at so people know, hey, I see, I'm seeing that right now. Miss Destiny 7B 8A Detroit, Michigan 8B. No, that ain't no 8B. That's 6B. 6B. Okay, I thought so. Let's see. Fort Worth, Texas, zone 8. Green Organic Love. I'm trying to catch people. Oh, okay, keep going. Sweet Potiker Garden Lab Farmer 73. Said, what's your grow zone? My grow zone is 8A. So just because my grow zone is 8A, I don't know what my microclimate is on my land. Because I'm by water, I'm down in a valley. That changes all kind of dynamics. So, okay. I'm going to get off of this. I wish I had one more device. I'm going to get off of here because what I want to see... Oh, this don't got the doggone community on it.
What you trying to see?
I wanted to answer some of their questions off of the community or set up the other computer so I could read those questions off to them. So I can answer to the, where's the other ones? You doing work.
That slow one.
Well, all I need to do is answer some questions. So, okay. Yeah. Turn me on. Not like, but. Anyway. Okay. It's all right. All right. This is what we gonna do. I wanted to answer questions, videos, from a couple of different videos y'all been asking me. Hey, game nerd, how you doing? Hey. I just looked up and caught that. Beat me up. Beat me up, Mr. Scott. Oh, I can see better now. DJ Tony Five Star, Linda Maxey, Stephanie Allen. My name, greetings. Tamika Montgomery, Columbia, South Carolina. Oh, Tamika Montgomery, email me. We neighbors. Hey, everybody. It's so good to see everybody tonight. My Wi-Fi, I don't know whether it's this mess is going on or what, but the Wi-Fi been tripping, and I'm glad if it glitch out tonight, I don't know what to tell you because, honestly, it been tripping lately.
You so,
man, I'm talking to the people.
Oh, I'm sorry. You got my computer, I figured.
I only got two hands. I can't type like you with little baby fingers. I can't type that fast. That pollen got me by the grapes. thank you, mama, daughter, sister. I just seen. Is that who the... Yeah, thank you. She said, where's your hot toddy for the sniffles? You already know I'm ready for the sniffles. So, mama, daughter, sister... And it's a lot of Carolinians in the house tonight. guava before I even get started. Guava, my friends. Thank you, everybody. And I hope everybody is safe. For all your family members that might be inflicted by this problem, all prayers going up for you. Please stay safe. Use your head. Use your head before we even get started. This is a mess. I'm not going to get on to that. Not tonight. It's too depressing. It's real, but you can get depressed real quick. So thank you. Guava, everybody. Ooh. Oh, Julie Nelson, thank you very much. She's in Sacramento, 9B. Sorry you have a cold and a back cough. No cold, just allergies that happen every year. If you look at my videos, every year around this time, I sound like this, like I got two corks in my nose. Uh-oh. Thank you, Ruby's Angel, thank you. Wow, to y'all, thank you so much. I appreciate you, I really do. This is my own special blend. Y'all see me make it. This is one. I added a little bit of the reason why we're here. I know my glasses don't be. These are actually Lady Led throwing them at me, made me put them on. Guava. This one, this batch of lead poison got the honey in it. So, guava, we're going to start like that tonight. So hopefully that honey is helping me. Now, the reason we're here tonight, a lot of people, I did a video on the update of our little patio garden after a couple of weeks. Guava, Ruby's Angel, thank you. Guava. Y'all got to take a shot with me too now. Bring out your jars or your glasses. Raise it up. I ain't going to be drinking by myself now. Make me put on my old man face. So, thank you, Ruby's Angel. Thank you. Guava to you, my friend. Ooh. Now, I made some pretty good stuff right there, if I do say so myself. So, I'm going to say this. Everybody saw the update of the patio garden. And you killing me, Nakia Darby. Thank you, Guava. Guava, Nakia Darby. Let's lighten this load a little bit. Thank you. Let's get right. We're going to get into it after this. Guava, my friend. Thank you. Y'all a mess. We got the update on the patio garden. But you know what, everybody... It was impressive even to me. I've done it before, but for some reason, it's just growing like wildfire. The peaches is on the tree. Tomatoes is on the plants. Cabbage is starting to head up. Collard green leaves look like doggone flippers on a seal. Thank you, Just One Ella. Thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. Let me get this thing so I can see better. Baby, help me. You know I'm legally blind. There we go. Thank you so much, Ella. Just One Ella. I appreciate that. Guava to you, my friend. Thank you so much. Now y'all know I got to work in the morning. Yeah, just a little sip. I sip you. Miss Craft, there you go. She would show up. Miss Craft, thank you. Guava, Miss Craft. Hey, Lady Linda, the New Orleans gardener in the house tonight. Oh, I'm in love. Y'all, I got folks in here. This is why I love doing this. Sometimes I be like, I want to go in there, but I don't want to get people. Some people be sad because I can't answer them right off the bat. And if y'all seen how fast this screen move, I try so much. And all the comments, I try so much. But I'm trying. I'm working on it. Okay? Doing some speed reading rainbow technique. Guava, everybody. Thank you for all the love. Thank you. Let's get into it though. Out of that patio garden, you know what I got more comments on and more emails on was this. Things have changed over the years. Y'all remember seeing this box out there by my peach tree on the patio garden? Everybody's they loved the garden, but they was like, teach me how to catch bees. I want to know how to catch bees. I've been trying to show people how to catch bees for years. For years. Starduster in the house. I don't see my girl, but I see somebody saying hey to her. Hey, Starduster. I can't see your face, lady. So, somebody said, you are garden fired, Lynn 70. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Green organic love. Thank you, little lady. You know you the one got me juicing in the first place. So thank you. The whole celery thing, celery butts, that's because of you. Thank you, Green Organic Love. And thank you. Who was that? Oh, that was you. Thank you. Guava, Miss Green Organic Love. Thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. There she is. Hey, Starduster. I see you. I see you, lady. I saw your video today. And you see, I had to do a quick comment. I had to pull over and comment on you. Ruby's Angel said, hey, everyone. Hey, everybody. Everybody, welcome everybody in the house. Now, I got a mission. I'm not going to say that. I want to see more beekeepers this year. So, I want to give y'all a couple of pointers. And any question you got, I'm going to be making sure I answer beekeeping questions because we need more beekeepers. The only way you're going to be a beekeeper is if you know what's going on. And I get a lot of this, ooh, I'm allergic to bees. Wrong bees. Oh, bees sting you hard or they be angry. Wrong bees. Everybody, okay, I'm going to start answering questions right off. Hey, there she is, White Flowers Homestead. How you doing, little lady? Guava, it's good to see you in the house tonight. Thank you. Thank you so much. Woo. Okay. Wait. Okay, I got you, Tamika Montgomery. I got you. Okay, slow these questions down. Are you with me or are you doing something else? Okay, get your work on, baby. Make that money, don't let that money make you. Okay. Let me see, these glasses, they ain't progressing nothing to me. Tracy Glenn, are you?
Well, take them off, cause you're not even looking through them.
But I look good in them. I just felt more important. Felt like I could take them off and turn to a damn superhero.
You couldn't even look at them.
I know. It just.
These got the same magnification as the ones you got.
I just felt special. Okay? I just wanted to wear the glasses.
look over them at people.
I wanted to feel important. Hey, David Heyman, thank you so much. Dave from Detroit. My grandma is from Toledo. Whoa, okay. You're doing great work. Showing the basics on repeat is so needed at this time. Exactly. And you know what? I always thank you and tell her in Toledo, I wonder where she at. The reason I do some of these repeat videos is because everybody don't get a chance to see them. And then they ask me the same question over and over instead of being like, just go look at the damn video. Ain't no problem redoing it. Every year I do grafting videos. Every year I do air layer videos, so on and so forth. Some people just don't see them. And sometimes I learn something new and add it to that. So let's get into it. I'm giving y'all a chance right now. It's a lot of people in here, so take it easy on me to ask your questions. that y'all been asking me all week. And when y'all asking them questions, y'all see that stuff pop up. I see it pop up while I'm driving at work, and I cannot answer you. I'm handing mail out the window, and it'll be like, hey, Led, where do you get your seeds from? Oh, man, that's a toughie. Miss Mama Pinup, I want to say, I hope I didn't cut that up. Thank you so much. Oh, that's dry. Thank you. I better take that easy, too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know. I got to work. I'm taking it. I'm a sip. Put my pinky out. I got to say guava with a little bit more elegance. Guava. Thank you. If I can afford the boxes, hives, what else can I use? Okay. Perfect. My very first beehive, our very first beehive, I built it from scratch. We did not go buy. It's the boxes that you normally see at a bee yard is called the Langstroth Hive. I'm not going to begin to lie to you. It's expensive. Hey, Kitten Black, how you doing? The Langstroth Hive is expensive. It's an investment. Okay, it's not something you just want to jump in if you don't really want to do this. Now, I just want to say that and get that out of your head right out the bat. Everybody with these real questions, if I pass you, email me tonight. I'm going to answer them tonight before I go to bed. I'm going to try my hardest, okay? Okay, give me a second. Blow brains out. Okay, so the very first hive I ever built was called an African top bar hive. That's all you do is build a 4 foot long wooden box, 1 foot deep. Remember, 4 foot long, 1 foot deep. Yeah, how far the frames did I make them? 16 inches? I have to measure. But I looked on YouTube. And I figure people that was living in third world countries, if they can make it out of nothing, I know I can make it out of Home Depot scraps. And I did it. And I got a video that I'm going to link under this when I'm done. And guess what? That hive was awesome. I had a couple of failures with it because I didn't know no better when I first started. I left the bottom open like a dummy. But we fixed that. And my first swarm I ever caught was because those bees absconded from that hive. They left that hive because they was like, man, there ain't even no floor in here. So once we figured that out and fixed it, I got tons of bees, tons of honey. Give me some of that ice, baby. Tons of bees, tons of honey. And that's what got us all the experience. Most of the experience I have is from an African top bar hive. For people that's looking into, you just want to learn about the bees first, which you should. Do me a favor. Get this beautiful stuff out of your head. Because if you're in it just to get this, I advise you don't be a beekeeper. It's the same way I told people about being a nurse. If you getting in it just for the money, please don't be a nurse. Please, because you're going to hurt people. If you getting into beekeeping just to get honey, please don't do it. As much as we need beekeepers, I'd rather you not. Because once you learn how to take care of the bees going to give you this and this. And this every time. They gonna give you this whether you want it or not. You just gotta take care of the bees. Okay? Now, so to me, your very first learning curve should be on a top bar hive. It's easy. It's so much simpler. It's so much easier. Trust me. But once you do that, the Langstroth hive, the ones that y'all used to be seeing, the boxes, those give you way more honey. Hands down. The top bar hive give you more bees. Produces more bees. The Langstroth produces way more honey. And for all of those, before I start answering questions, for all of those people that's getting into this, do me a favor. Do not mention that new age hive at all. Because it's a piece of junk, and I don't care if they know about me saying it or not. If you think you're going to get honey and not have to put in no work, that's like you going out to your garden and peeing on the grass and hope you got an apple tree come out tomorrow. If you ain't ready to put in no work and no sweat, I even got a honey video, honey harvest video, where somebody said, oh, your shirt all sweaty. It's hard work. I didn't take that shirt off for a reason. Just to show you, this ain't for the week. You out there at 100 degrees outside, and it's time to pull honey. Time to check your hives. Go. They ain't waiting for you. And if you don't, they're going to leave. Okay? So, this ain't for no punks. I'm just letting you know. Everybody think it's cute. It ain't cute. It's cool to see. It's cool to do. But any beekeeper know it's not cute. Okay? You out there sweating. Your junk. Yup. I said don't mention that hive. Wheel 45. Let me tell you something. Yeah. Junk. Because only people, you see people use it. Now, I'm going to tell you who you see use that thing. People that has been endorsed by that thing. Only people, let me tell you something. As much as that one stupid hive costs, you can buy five big hives. You trying to, like my dad used to say, sometimes the long way is the shortcut. Sometimes the hard way is the easy way. Don't shortcut this. This one thing you can't shortcut. You understand? It's one of those things. I'm going to get in here. Wait, I just seen somebody say they're a beekeeper. Simply. Simply. Yarenti, I think that is. My daughter's a beekeeper. Oh, your daughter's a beekeeper. What does she think about that weird hive that they invented? My personal opinion and every other beekeeper I know it's junk. You cannot function with that. You can't move. You can't tell a bee what to do. And that hive, they're telling you that you're telling bees what to do. All you got to do is go in there, turn the little faucet knobs and honey fly out. Go unleash some honey. Outside of an active hive and watch what happened to your ass. Okay? It ain't just the bees gonna get you. Every walk of life want this. You might have a squirrel on your head scratching your eyes out. You don't know. This stuff is precious. Everything smell this honey. Y'all see me in some of those videos, I start moving real fast, don't I? I ain't scared of just the bees getting me. I'm scared of every other walk of life to smell it. It'll wake up a polar bear. One of the black bears in the cave. They smell that. Okay, now, let's get into it. I'm getting in some questions. Hey, Kitten Black. Oh, that's old. I'm sorry. Somebody got blocked. What was that? Let me make sure. Oh, that's so old to go. Okay, all right, questions. What do you want to know? And I'm going to do my best to help you. I'm going to tell you one thing right now. Before I get started, I'm going to give you one of the biggest tips that you can get. Go to the store and get you like a banker's box. Okay, like you put files in. We used to try to catch swarms with those, and it was working. Either buy one of these frames or make it. Want to know what? I was making my own frames at first. I didn't know nothing about these. We was making them out of the little 2x2 strips that you use for to hold your carpet down and stuff like that. Shit, we made them. My first hive was 100% self-made. The only thing we did was buy that first package of bees. We never bought another package of bees ever. Because I'm going to show you how to catch them. Right now, I don't have any bees in my yard. They were killed off by another hive. But guess what? You know why I ain't buying no more? Because they out there already. I ain't released a video looking at my hive. About to move back in and get another miracle hive. I'm going to show you how to do this. And one of the biggest keys, you need three things. You need a box. Okay? Let's start here. You need a box with a lid on it. And if it ain't got a lid on it, try to put something over top of it to cover it up from the weather. I'm going to tell you how to bait it. Let me see. Trust is 100% self-made hive impressive. Yes, thank you. Thank you. I did that myself. I'm going to put up the pictures so you will see. It wasn't no video back then. I was just taking pictures of my progress. So, okay. How do you prevent wasps from getting in? Baby. She's spinning stuff all over the computer. You tired, baby? Oh. Okay. You don't prevent wasps from getting in. The honeybees will prevent the wasps from getting in. See, don't worry about wasps. Don't even worry about them. Honeybees is cute, but they do everything. You don't do nothing. I don't do nothing to my bees. They prevent all those diseases and all of the little pests that get inside the hive. You got to leave them alone. Everybody say, oh, you got to add this acid. You got to add this. Leave them alone. I've been successful by letting them do what they want to do. Everybody say, hey, baby.
Hey, yo.
Okay. Ms. Krabs said, bees are gangster. Yes, they are. Yes, they are some gangsters. So, okay. Just got my bee box today. What kind of bee box do you got? The Langstroth hive? How do you protect hives during windstorms? Great question. Because I found that out the hard way. Matter of fact, the way I protected it saved it from something else. We had a flood out here about 6 years ago. I strapped them down with the cranking strap that you use for cars to hold down something in the trailer, the ratchet straps. I ratchet strap my boxes when it's going to get windy. Get this. The flood swept away my homemade hive that I made, and it floated down the lake, 2 miles down the lake. Hear me? Like Noah's Ark. I can't make this up. Like Noah's Ark, and landed in a neighbor's yard. And he finally told me like a month later, like all the neighbors in the neighborhood said, you're a beekeeper. I think I got something that belongs to you. Went to his house, and there's my big hive, still in perfect condition. If he said, everybody saw it floating down there, and it landed in my yard. Here's the thing. It was an ark, and it looked like Noah's Ark. Once I show you the pictures, you will see exactly what I'm talking about. Trust me, it wasn't intentional to be that way. But it looked like Noah's Ark, and it was full of God's creatures, and it made it to the other side. Only thing, that sucker robbed me, see? He thought I was stupid. Once I looked into the hive, I seen it had basically killed off some of the bees, carved out my damn honey, ate it. Talk about I could have the box back. No, you get rid of that, sucker. He thought I was stupid, see? Anyway, that's a true story. So, use ratchet straps, and those ratchet straps hooked together, didn't let the lid come up and everything, and it held water, and it floated all the way down the lake. So, ratchet straps for high wind or bungee straps, anything like that. Okay, any more questions? That was a good question. Oh, do I put their feed in the box or out? I prefer you put the feed in the box. Now, do you know what kind of feed you use? You just use sugar water, right? Or give them their honey back Everybody always like, hey, Led, you always say you don't got no honey, but you always got plenty of it on the videos. Because this belongs to them. Some of this is mine, but I feed their honey back to them. This is their medicine. They make this for them, not for me. So this is the way you keep your bees healthy. You want sick, dead, dying bees? Keep giving them old raggedy-ass sugar water that you done stirred up. You'll get sick bees real quick. You'll get sick bees. You'll get ants. You'll get everything else. For some reason, nothing messes with this. So as much as you can, feed your bees back their own food that you got out of their pantry. Okay? Don't rob, when you pull honey off, when y'all see me with those gallons and gallons and gallons and gallons of honey, I need you to understand something. I, out of all of those, last year I took off maybe 15 gallons of honey off that one hive. Want to hear something? I also only took no more, either half or one third. You only take one third to half, leave the rest in the box for them. So imagine, if I took off 10 or 15 gallons, I just left 10 or 15 gallons in the box. So if you wanted to kill all your bees, yeah, you'd get 30 gallons of honey. Now you do the math on that, a 30-gallon trash can of pure raw honey. So, okay, can we start with giving them store-bought honey? Absolutely not. They do not like that crap because it's not honey. Everybody think that's honey. It is not honey. Anybody can attest to this. Anybody that I sent some of this, that's not what you taste in the store. It don't taste like that. And want to hear something? This jar don't taste like this jar. Look at the differences in them. One is dark. One you can see straight through. Look at my face behind that one. Look at it in that one. That means this is real. These bees make whatever they want. Want to see something even freakier than that? Watch this. Even darker. Even darker. This tastes like blackberries. Okay? Bees don't make one kind of damn honey. They make all different shades of it for different reasons. Some honey tastes like garlic. Some honey tastes like apples. Some honey tastes like blackberries. Some honey tastes like citrus. This is a citrusy tasting. So I like, when people was buying the honey, I would send citrus honey to this one. If they bought two jars, I would send them like a citrus and a berry. Or I send them a little sample of some garlic, citrus, berry. So you see, it's always different. Anybody that say, oh, I got it from Walmart, I don't like honey, guess what? My mama hate honey. She hated it until she tasted this. She ain't never had real honey in her life till we became beekeepers. Okay, Ninu24, true, is whatever the bees pollinated from. Exactly. My favorite is spicy, ultra-raw buckwheat honey. You want to know something? We don't know what this is until we taste it. You can't control that. The only way you can control that is if you're enslaving the bees, you're making them go to almond fields, citrus groves. That's slavery to me. That's for the big industrial people. Do me a favor. Get that big industrial crap out your head unless you got like acres and acres and acres. Number one. Number two, if that's all you want to do for your life, you can't do this. You can't have a beehive operation and do nothing else. You can't have no other full-time or part-time job. It ain't going to happen. Get that out of your head. Okay? So, I'm just letting you know, if anybody tell you you can just put 50 hives on your land and then go to work and have a normal life, no, get that out of your head. Once you have one beehive and see how much work it takes, and how much time it takes, you ain't just rushing through there like you cutting grass, okay? You taking care of these bees. You don't want to squish them. They're easy to squish. Once you start squishing them, you piss them off. Okay? Don't do that. Don't do that. Because honeybees don't bother you until you piss them off. Other bees just sting you because they ain't got nothing better to do. But the rest of them, hey, Honey Limited, hey, Green Organic Love, and hey, Rose 5150, how you doing? I didn't see you. I seen somebody say, hey. Okay, I'm with you, y'all. I'm sorry. Let me tell you something. There's certain things you can tell I get real passionate about and I fly off the handle. Bees is one of them. So please, excuse me. Let me get in here and answer some more questions. If I didn't answer your question yet, throw it back at me. I'm here for you tonight. I'm not going to try to just go run it off at the mouth tonight. I really want some questions because I really want as many I want as many new beekeepers in the game as I can get. Can you keep bees on 1/8 of an acre? You can. You know what? I got a beehive on my front porch. You see it? I had a beehive at my garage door. Let me see. So all we need is a box and lemongrass oil. Here's the thing. True story. Lemongrass oil, they say, works like a charm. Here's the problem why lemongrass oil has never really worked out for me. Because you have to make sure that it's real, 100% pure lemongrass oil, which everybody, just like this honey, it's hard to find because everybody trying to make a profit. They cut that lemongrass with some other kind of oil, bees won't touch it. They won't touch it. If you buying that stuff off of some of these online stores, Walmart, bees won't touch it. I'm going to show you. Hey, Loving Life, Houston, how you doing? What was that? How can I make a purchase? Well, I ain't got no honey right now. When I get some, I'm going to post it up for everybody. I'm going to show you the best bait in the world. Let me see. What does she do with my stuff? Oh. Them ain't dookie balls. Them ain't dookie balls. I didn't pick this up behind somebody's dog. You know what that is? If you know a beekeeper or you live close to a apiary, ask them for a piece of their honeycomb. That's right, RB. Ask them for a piece of their honeycomb out of an active hive. Number one, listen to me close because I'm giving you a mean pointer that don't nobody tell you. The darker, the uglier, the blacker that honeycomb is, it don't look like a honeycomb no more, the better bait it is. Because that's old comb is what they call it. Old comb. The smell drives bees crazy. And that's what actually makes them attack your hive and try to see what's going on in there. That's what happened to my hive. I left too much old comb in there. You need to recycle that. Get rid of it. The old comb looks awful. Okay? And old comb attracts pests like hive beetles, wax moth. You want to kind of get rid of as much old comb as you got. So what I do, I recycle a bunch of frames, cut that honey out. Just cut it out. When you spin the honey out of it, because the honey is still beautiful, spin the honey out and then cut the whole frame out and put the frame back in empty like this. It used to have a comb in it. Cut that out. Use that for your bait. New comb like this works too. So when I'm gathering all the honey up, I keep some of the wax and I put it in a plastic bag and put it away anywhere. It don't rot, it ain't gonna stink, it ain't gonna mold, nothing. They make stuff to last forever. And the biggest part is, think of, I want you to get deep with me real quick. I'm gonna take you down a couple levels, okay? An insect not only just made one of the most purest foods on the planet from flowers, it also made a structure that's not just healthy, but it's also flammable. So if you think about it, they made a flammable material that burns constant and burns slow from a little bee. It made you food, energy, and health benefits from the propolis. That's a whole other ball game we ain't gonna get into right now. Cause that's getting a little deeper than where I wanna take you right this minute. So now, let me see, here we go. I would like bees, but I'm allergic. Wrong bees. That's the stuff why people always say, I don't wanna be a beekeeper cause I'm allergic to bees. You ain't allergic to honeybees, I promise you. Most people is allergic to wasps, yellow jackets. Yellow jackets kind of look like honeybees, but once you start keeping bees, you can identify every single kind of bee, and you know good and well. You even start knowing the difference between honeybees. Me and Lady Led the other day, we knew our bees. Somebody asked me a year or so ago, how do you know they're your bees? Because I told them our bees came back. Our bees had a specific look to them. Before we came to this neighborhood, these neighbors said they hadn't seen bees in years till we moved here. We had some African all black bees. They was huge. They was kind of mean. No, they weren't Africanized bees, I don't think. They was kind of pissy. But if you seen how much honey they pumped out, I think that might have been the strongest honey year we had ever had. They kept pumping out 5 gallon buckets, 5 gallon buckets, 5 gallon buckets. Once we saw those black bees on our collard greens, we let our greens go to seed. Once we seen them black bees on, they coming back. We started looking at the hives that we left out there. They humming around. Oh, please come back. It's like you send your kid off to college, baby. Come home for a little while. Come on home and let daddy talk to you, you know. That's how I felt. I got excited. When I get to talk about bees, I get in my feelings because you don't know what this tastes like. Some of y'all do because you got something from me. Ain't nothing like this. Every night, remember I just put that post up and I said, you don't need the cure if you already got the prevention. Please, tonight, go Google what's in pure raw honey and the benefit of honeybees. And you will see. Me and Lady Led take a couple spoonful of that every night. Don't heat it up. Don't put it in tea. Don't put it in coffee. Eat it raw. Once you eat that raw, and with my allergies, I need to eat another spoonful. Lettuce to Lunch said, pure raw honey is a gift from nature. Yes, it is. It is. It's pure. Can I use a chest box? Want to hear something? Yes, you can. Hey, Stardust said, yeah. Yes, you can. Because I got a friend that actually mentored me and Lady Led. You know what she had? She had an old dresser drawer. Yeah. Like, one of them real ones made out of real wood like your grandma got. She drilled a hole in that sucker and they did something on the inside. And that, she said, that's just for them. She never went in it or nothing. She made it out of a dresser drawer. And it's still there to this day. Somebody just said, honey never spoils. I got some of this honey. I kid you not. Because we got our own stash. I ain't going to tell you where it is. From 8 years ago. I don't know how long this been in here. I think this honey been in here like maybe 5 years. in this jar. And we just put this on the table kind of like for show. That's why I always put it in the screen because it's always sitting right here in front of me. Hey, Nick Thomas, good to see you, my friend. Good to see you. Oh, Essien Garden family in the house. What's up, Sapper? Good to see you. I can't see you, but I seen somebody say, what's up to you? Okay, glass is better, I see. Okay, I'm with the questions again. I'm back in it. I'm back in it, y'all. I'm back in it. The Libra goddess, yes, 5 years. Listen, they found this in Egyptian tombs. Crystallized. You want to see some crystallized, honey? I wish Lady Leia was down here. I'm going to show you something right now. Y'all probably see me. I'm going to show you something crazy right now. Okay. I'm going to show you something. Kind of what they found. Well, I'm going to do you one better. I'm going to do you one better. I'm going to show you what they found in Egyptian tombs. Now, this is my own stash. This ain't nothing I send out. See, that got dust on the lid. See that? I'm going to show you something. Stick with me. Guava real quick. Okay. That is more citrus tasting honey. See how clear it is? This is crystallized honey. This honey, very few people bought it because it's expensive, and I sold it for expensive. And I'm going to tell you something. Know your worth. Never try to get money just because you're trying to get by. Know your worth. And that goes to all these people in here. Know your worth before I go on. This is something my father told me. If you feel that your worth, some people say, $25 for some honey. I ain't paying that for no honey. Don't buy it. Can I get it for 10? No. And I'm going to tell you why. Because I know what I did. I know that I'm giving you the truth. I know I'm giving you pure, raw. Another man can tell you whatever you want, but I'm showing you on video. I'm showing you can look at these cans and see them in the video. You're getting the exact same thing. And I know what I'm worth. I know what my time is worth. I know what I'm giving you. I'm giving you the truth. So when you do get into any kind of business in your life, or if you listen, if you get into, say, designing clothes, you sell those clothes for what is what you are worth. Don't sell them clothes for what you think people gonna pay for it. You sell them clothes for what you feel that you're worth. Because I'm gonna tell you this. What's the difference between a Chevy and a Maserati? What's the difference between a Chevy Impala and a Maserati? Nothing. That name. They both take your ass back and forth to work to pay for them. Right? You got to pay for both of them. One costs more than the other one. It's a status symbol. People drive Mercedes, and my son is a Mercedes mechanic, and he said, this is one of the worst cars ever made. Why do people buy them? It's a status quo. It's for status to say, hey, I got money. See what I'm saying? Why do people keep buying Mercedes and Maserati knowing they ain't no different than a Chevy Impala? Why do they keep buying them? And why don't Mercedes come down on their prices? You know why Mercedes don't come down on their prices? Because they feel this is what we're worth, buy it or don't. And people, human nature make you think it must be something about that car because this show costs a lot of money. Look at all the rappers and entertainers. They go after what they want, a Bentley. Ain't no different. You know what I'm saying? You sell yourself for what you feel yourself is worth. Let's get dirty now. I'm going back to the hood with it. It's some hookers out there. It's some street walkers out there. Some of them are selling for $5. And some are selling for $5,000. Okay? And the only difference is, because they, you know, is she feel that's what hers is worth. And she get classier clients. If the woman just down there itching on the corner, if she just cleaned up a little bit and said, look, from now on, I got to have at least $1,500. She might get it. You know, comb her hair a little bit, brush her tooth. You know, I'm just saying, whatever you do in life, if you get in the business for yourself, don't sell yourself short. And sometimes it won't work and nobody's going to buy your product. But if it don't work and they ain't buying what they feel that you worth, they just don't know your worth. So don't sell them. Don't say, okay. From now on, these shirts is only $5. Get two for five. No, because now they know you're cheap and you're sorry. And you're begging for help. Don't do that. Know your worth. So when people ask me, can I get that honey for $10? No, you cannot. I sold a lime tree 2 days ago, a cutting. And I said, sir, you $20. And he said, for this? Yeah. Can I get it for $10? No. Because I know what I did to that thing. He trying to match it up to what he see in the stores. All you got to do if you don't like it, they got them over there. But once he see what I do back here, and I already got lemons and limes growing on the trees, a little different than Home Depot, ain't it? I know my worth. And I'm not going to sell myself short. So I'm just telling you that because once you get into beekeeping, who did this? Thank you, Carlos Spices. Thank you so much. Guava. I didn't even see that. I just caught it out that glimpse of my eye. Thank you so much, Guava, to you. I appreciate that. I really do. Okay? Never sell yourself short. So thank you. The only reason I say that is because if you're passionate about something like beekeeping, you know what you put into it. You know what you did to it. You know what you did for them bees. Not only did you take care of these bees, they produce honey for you to sell. You also help save the world. I think that's worth a couple more nickels. You know what I'm saying? People don't look at it like that. When you get deep into this, you'll see. Everybody said this. Oh, Led, you ain't just putting eggshells and shit under them trees. We ain't listening to that. Come on. And I told one guy, you right. He said, your bees had to have something to do with it. Because mine don't do that. And I've been putting eggshells on ever since I saw your video 4 years ago. You might be right. So get some bees. So, it's a big difference in my garden when everything is blooming. Bonita out there blooming. Rasputia blooming. Norbit ass is alive. He waking up. And the bees is all over them. They ain't in my yard, but they coming. They my bees. I claimed them. They coming back. You will see. So, okay, Starduster said, do what works for you. Exactly. Do what works for you. Now, I'm going to get back in here. Okay. Raw unfiltered honey cure my whole household allergies. That's why I need to. Look, for some reason, this is the stuff we've been eating. We got another jar of this we've been eating. I need to get some of this Black Thunder. That Black Thunder, them crystallized. This crystallized honey, this is what it do. Soon as you put it on your tongue, it melts and wraps around your whole tongue. Kind of like when you put caramel on an apple, like, you know, around that time of the year, people put the candy apple and they wrap around the apple and melt around slow. And it make my mouth water. It dissolves in your mouth like nothing I never felt before. I can't even explain it because you'll be like, oh, they're going to let it again with them descriptions. Okay, Angel Devon says your customer is someone willing and able to buy your product. Period. Exactly. And you know what? Oh, Starduster said yes, yummy. Starduster, I think Starduster has some. Nick Thomas had some. Miss Craft has some. The people I could just see right off the bat. Telling you, I can't tell you what Miss Craft experienced with her honey, because this jar I'm holding might not taste the same. This one might not taste the same as that. But I promise you, none of it tastes like the grocery store. Hey, Cheryl's Organic Food Force, how you doing, Lady Cheryl? Good to see you tonight. So, let's get to this, okay? Okay, so I seen another question. How do you make the beehive? Do me a favor, go online and get the measurements of the beehive. If you want to build the top bar hive, please do me a favor. You can build the Langstroth. Don't try to build that yet, especially if you don't have any woodworking skills at all. Build a top bar hive to get you started. It's easier. It's very, 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 very cheap. I went overboard, but really my first hive I ever built really should have cost me like 20 or 30 bucks. But I went stupid with it. And, you know. Anyway, I made it all fancy. Anyway. But yeah, do that. Now, if you're interested in getting a Langstroth, the normal kind of boxes that you see me with all the time, that's expensive. Not going to lie to you. It's expensive. Once you buy one box and you buy some bees, your bees going to cost you like 130 bucks somewhere around there, depending on where you get it from. I promise you. That should be the only pack of bees you'll ever buy in your life. Ever. Now, I'm going to show you something that another one of our friends here in the Greenhouse Lounge, I wish I could put his video up right now because he's living proof. Listen, homeboy, if you're watching, you my dog, so this ain't bad on you, okay? He kept bugging me. Larry, he kept emailing me. I kept seeing emails, Facebook, YouTube, every video. Led, you got to get back with me, man. I need you. What's going on, man? I got these bees. I want to get these bees. This dude is serious. Either he's a lunatic. Either he's a lunatic or he's serious. You know, that's a thin line sometimes on this internet. He said, tell me how to get them bees. I need to know. I watched your video the other day. You showed me. It was alive and it was like an hour long. I want to know. I said, okay, I'll do that. So here we go. I'm going to show you right now what I did. My man caught a swarm by doing exactly what I said. I'm going to find that video, and if I find it, I'm going to ask him, can I put it up? Because I want to show you it's not as hard as you think. Everybody think everything is so freaking hard. No. You take a box. You don't necessarily need these. The only reason you need these frames is because it's easier when you're taking them out this box to put them in another hive. You don't need that. You get you a cardboard box, like a filing box. Here you go. I got a couple. Here you go. Chicken box you get from like Sam Club or something. Get your chicken box. Leave that alone. Just get you a box, okay? Let's go back to this. Get you a box. You get you some, used wax, used honeycomb, not out the store. So everybody caught that last box. Lady Liz said, don't you show them that. She said, don't you show them that. I said, no, I'm telling them. You can use whatever you need to use. Okay. She said, don't show them that because you're going to have everybody emailing us about Bojangle boxes. Y'all don't email me about Bojangle box. But you can use any... You can use any box you want, okay? Now you take this wax. Let me show you. See how, let me get in the camera. See how nasty that look? Fucking Bojangles. See how nasty that look? That's because this was I mixed some of the black stuff in there. The nasty comb I was telling you about, the dark stuff. I mixed some of that in there. And you can't ever get out all of the honey. See how it's shiny? I'm going to tell you something about this. You can eat this too. I could eat this right now. I'm not going to do it because I dropped a couple leaves on the ground out there and I don't know which one it was. And with the stuff going around, I might bite right into the virus. Like, so I don't want to do it. So this right here, you take that. It still got honey in my hands are sticky. Take your box. You can see where I rubbed it. See that? This is how easy it is. Like a child. Like a child with a crayon on your freshly painted walls. All around the box. As you scratch that inside the walls of that box, see that? You don't need lemongrass oil when you do this. Now on the outside, all around the outside, all around the hole on the inside. Now, this is the sweet part. Put your top back on. Make sure your top, if it's cardboard, make sure it's something on top. And this is what I like to use. Trust me, it works. You know when the political signs come out and after the people lose, it'd be hundreds of them political signs all over the place, right? Grab one of them suckers. They are waterproof forever. I use them in all my beehives. I got plenty of them in there. If you ever seen one of these political signs, no, 9 times out of 10, I did not vote for that person. I just used a sign for the bees, okay? I pulled it off the street somewhere. You lay it over top so the cardboard don't get wet. You don't want that to get squishy. So that's a good pointer. Put that political sign over top of that. Don't go be trying to buy a whole bunch of nonsense. Just get a political sign. They free, okay? Recycle. Lay it over top. Now you take your box and you go somewhere to a tree line. Anywhere. It could be like a baseball field, right? But not in the middle of the field where the kids be at. Right at the tree line where the trees start. As close to any kind of source of water that you could find. I don't care if it's standing water, stagnant water, a stream, a gutter, anything. Strap your box to a tree about 5 feet high and aim the hole away from the sun. If the sun is coming from that way, aim the hole this way. If the wind is coming from that way and it's blowing like this, aim the hole this way. They don't like a lot of wind and air on them, just like we don't. That pisses them off. They don't like a draft. You know how your grandma be like, close that window, I feel a draft. Bees ain't no different. You strap that up with a bungee cord or some zip ties or a ratchet strap and just go check on it once a week. Don't go messing with it. Don't go doing this. Don't do that, because if you had some bees in there, you ain't no more. You're going to have a busted eye. Okay? If you can't strap it up in a tree somewhere, go set it up on high on top of a building or something, because they look for these places up high. They look down at stuff, and they see bright colors, any kind of like iridescence. I'm going to tell you what they love. Clover. They love the color white and they love echinacea. Echinacea flowers drive them crazy. All bees, echinacea, the color of them, the spectrum of the color drives them insane. That's why we grow it. So, yeah, that's another one of my tricks that we bring them home. Grow echinacea, cone flowers, if you will. Okay? And that's how we get bees. Now, I have one question that I'm just remembering that I'm going to answer right now. Okay, but they can't see red. I don't know if they can or can't see red, but you don't want to paint your hives. Listen, here's another tip for that, okay? Don't paint your hive dark colors, because dark colors attract sun, and what that does is heat that box up. And you're going to burn their little babies up. And if it's too hot inside the box, they're going to try to fan it for a while. And after a while, they take the babies, take the honey, take them all and leave. You got an empty ass box in the morning. Paint your boxes. That's why when you see mine, they like pastel colors, white colors, bright colors, things that deflect the light, things that deflect heat, lighter colors. If you paint that box a dark color, brown, black, red, a dark green, they gonna fly away. You're gonna see your boxes on the outside of the hive more than you're gonna see them inside the hive. And when they on the outside of the hive, they ain't working. They too busy trying to keep the hive cool. They ain't out flying around hunting for honey, and they ain't inside tending to the babies. They ain't in there making honey. You wasting your time. So, let me see. Kent Johnson, guard, I use echinacea powder in my tea to fend off colds. Okay, I missed something. Okay. And it was something else. It was something I was going to get to. How often do you have to replace your queen bee? If you take care of your queen, really never. I mean, you can replace her if you want to. But see, that's where a lot of people, that's where I say you start messing with stuff too much. If your queen is producing, she pumping out babies, she making eggs, she in there doing her business, and the hive is calm and cool, don't go replacing her because some nitwit said, you're supposed to replace the queen every year or once every 6 months. Don't. We leave our queen alone. If the queen is producing, she laying eggs, she doing her business, the hive is calm. You can walk past. Y'all see me cutting grass. Y'all see the videos of me cutting grass, cutting them, acting a fool. I'm driving right past my hives. I'm not getting stung. I don't have on a beehive suit. They don't care about me. But if the queen is pissy, she ain't laying off. She ain't laying eggs. She acting funny. The bees get pissed off too. So if you notice your bees is all good, she's all good. Don't go in there every 5 minutes, want to see what the bees is doing. Leave them alone. Check them once a week. Everybody think they got to look in that beehive once every day. They gonna leave. It's just like somebody, strangers think. Strangers keep walking in your door like, oh, is Jim and them here? Man, they moved weeks ago. Man, close my door. If you people did that, kept doing that, man, we got to get out of here. Because I don't know who the hell Jim is, but he's popular, and I don't want his people in here. Bees ain't no different. Leave them alone. That's where people lose their bees. They keep bothering with them. You know what I'm saying? So that's been our success. Leave them alone. They say, oh, you got hive beetles. You need to get rid of them. They do it themselves. They make gels to capture the pests inside. And guess what? They keep them in there and they starve them. And then your dumb ass come open the box and let them all loose. That's like you opening up what's the rock? Alcatraz. Your dumb ass being nosy. I've done that several times. The bees can handle their own stuff. Trust me. Okay, this is off topic, but do you have a video of growing beans and okra? Nope. I don't believe I do. Let me get back here. It was another question. but I will have one for you, okay? New to the channel, do you do fruit trees? You need to watch a couple more videos. Then you will see, do I do fruit trees? Tell them, y'all. Okay, let me get back in here. Okay. How do you, who just did that? Thank you, Myra McClain. Guava, I'm just seeing that. Thank you so much. And Sirius Black, thank you so much. I'm sorry, I told you I get passionate about my bees. I get serious about my bees. Thank you, y'all. I appreciate you, Guava. Guava, thank you so much. It was about time for that anyway. But yes, I do fruit trees. I do a little bit of everything. This is an everything channel. So you will see, we make wine here. We grow fruit. We grow fruit trees. We grow vegetables. I show you how to do a little bit of everything. A little bit of prepping. A little bit of preparation. Some things, I guess you could say we talk about a little bit of relationships too. We do a little bit of everything in here, man. So, okay. Let me see. I do but veggies. Relocations. Yes, relocations. We do a little bit of relocations by that time too. Hey, Led, what grows with watermelon? I don't know. I don't even know what that question means. What grows with watermelon? Led, have you done jams and preserves? Let me tell you something off the subject. Now I'm going to do it off the subject. Is Meyer Lemon Bush really a treat? That, Google that. That, what? Why, what? somebody asked, do I do fruits, jams and jellies? Thank you, Rose Frazier. Thank you so much. Let's top that up. Thank you so much for that. You know what? We've been canning for years, but we use, come and give me the big pot. Where's the big pot? Give me that. Chop, chop. Boy, you move like you older than me.
Excuse me.
I just ate. We can and need in this big mama here. But, I'm about to throw it down. This is Cheryl's Organic Food Force. Now, let me tell you something. Now, this is a true story. I'm not a canner. Lady Led is the canner, okay? She does the canning. I always was like, I'm going to learn it. I'm going to get to it. Just never really have. I know how to do it, just never done it. Cheryl's Organic Food Forest, I watch her can because she's the canning queen. I said, damn it, I'm about to start canning again. I'm ready to learn. Every time y'all see me ready to learn, I learn y'all skills. These skills just ain't mine, y'all. For all the people that's in here, and you say, oh, thank you, Led, I'm learning from you. No, you're not. You're learning from all of us. Because everything I show you, I've learned from you. And I give props to everybody I learn from. Those cuttings, Rose 5150. Cannons, Cheryl's Organic Food Force. I can go on and on down the list. Okay? Now, with that being said, I'm going to give you one more that turned me on. Hydroponics, aquaponics, Miss Kraft. I'm going to give you one more. Miss Homestead Hart and her husband been pressure canning. Now, not only do I not know how to can very well, let's say this, I've never done it. I'm going to go hard, just like I did with the aquaponics. Not only did I do your aquaponics, Ms. Kraft, I hooked it up to a solar power system, and we was running off of solar. Okay? I took it up a notch, cut the heat up on it. So, for Ms. Homestead Hart, I ordered this after I watched her video. I bought a pressure canner. Miss Homestead Hart, this is going out to you. Thank you, sweetheart, you and your lovely husband, because you just put a fire under my tail between you, Lady Led, and Cheryl's Organic Food Forest. Let me bring up Miss Cheryl. I'm about to start canning. I can't have Lady Led doing this, and I don't know how to do it. So this just came in the mail today. between it's several people. And Miss Starduster and Miss Crab got me about to. Hey, come here, boy. Make you useful. Give me that big jar down there. I'm just showing y'all that these skills belong to all of us here on this channel in the Greenhouse Lounge. Not boy, the one with the stuff in it.
There's two big jars and you didn't specify which one.
Well, why would you grab the empty one? You think I'm about to drink out of it?
Yes. You would do that.
I would. I'll give you that. I'll give you that. And Miss Craft and Starduster 2 got me trying to make some kombucha. I don't know. It's for stomach health and guts. I'm going to do it. And my man, Sapper Gardner, Essien Garden Family, between Essien Garden Family and Dan Permaculture Food Forest, they got me some, what is that called? What is that stuff called, y'all? That root that stank like a toe. What's that root called? That stinking cassava. That's, yeah, you see Little Lead. Y'all, this is stuff from y'all. Thank you, baby, because I wasn't going to think of cassava for nothing. Starduster 2 and Miss Craft got me making this kombucha stuff. I'm almost scared of it. It just, I don't know the word. They need to call it something else, stomach seltzer or something. Kombucha just sounds like it's going to get me in some trouble. I don't know why. I just feel like, I don't know, feel like cops supposed to be called after I drink it. So, don't be, it is easy. I am, and I'm going to let you teach me how to do it. Okay? I told y'all, when people ask me all these sophisticated questions, I'm not the know-all, end-all, be-all of gardening at all. All of the skills that I've acquired over the years and in my life become, I assimilate you into me. Things I learn, I keep that in my head. How to make fire, all of that stuff, out of nothing. I told you. Come on now. This is y'all. All of this stuff is y'all. And then when people say, oh, you did this. No, I can't get all the credit off of that. I ain't gonna take all the credit of it. You saw me do it, but I'm gonna tell you who showed me how to do it. And I even give credit to grafting from some people that I don't know. They don't speak no English, and they was off in the woods with no shoes on. That's where I learned that from, so I can't give them no credit. I wish I could give them some credit, little rascals. They was good at it, too. Okay, I'm still collecting lint. Oh, I missed something. Do a first pressure canning. I don't want to see y'all, let y'all see me blow myself up. Let me see. Lead, add wine to your kombucha. See, y'all taking me too far. I know, I better do one thing. Lady Lead said, one thing at a time. One thing at a time. So, yeah, I'm going to try, but one thing at a time. What's in the cup? Liquid lead. If you don't know what liquid lead is, I got a video on it too. Something we all made here in the Greenhouse Lounge together. You see the sweat crying out my forehead. This is liquid lead, owner, CEO. This is wine that we all made here in the Greenhouse Lounge together. I showed everybody how to make it. We all made it. So after you make it, you drink it. And I made a couple gallons of it. And this some of the best stuff I ever made in my life. I'm going to be honest with you. It's delicious. Miss Ashia, only 43 people hit the thumbs up. It's okay. You know what I always say? I never get into that. I'm going to tell you why. Can't make everybody like you. If they don't like you, they just don't like you. You can't make folks like you. You know what I'm saying? That's why I never say that. You know, hit thumbs up stuff. Some people don't like what you're saying. And they got the right, you know what I'm saying? Just because you come to see something, I watch a lot of stuff. She had me watching one of these old movies, and the whole half of the movie, I'm looking like, I'm watching it because I want to be with my wife while, but do I want to watch this? No. You know, so to each his own. No problem with that. No problem, Serena Leo. I hope I didn't butcher your name. It's okay. Thank you so much. Right. Let me see. Victory Begins in the Garden. Romantic comedy. Don't get me wrong. I like some of that stuff. But she can get real exquisite with the movie picks. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I don't want to watch. How can I put this? Ain't no good way to put it. I don't feel like watching a slave picture all the time. Because it don't do nothing but make me mad. You know what I'm saying? She'd go up there and watch like Roots. Shit, you know what I'm saying? She'd go and cut on Roots and stream Roots, you know. And after that first, I'm like this. You know what I'm saying? This ain't a heartfelt. I'm not going to bed happy after this movie. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to want no romance either after I watch Roots and shit. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. Don't get me wrong. I watch them when I need some education. I want to watch them to get in the mood for, you know, my people. But that ain't something I want to come home from work and a long day and people been calling me all kind of names and stuff. And I'm mad at my boss, and now you're gonna have me watch Roots? You know what I'm saying? Or her favorite show, The Underground? I don't wanna see that right now. Because it's gonna piss me off. You know what I'm saying? And then tomorrow I'm gonna go to work, cussing folks out. I don't wanna do that. You know, I don't wanna do that. And I go in there with my fist up and everything else, done wore a black leather glove. I don't wanna do that. You know what I'm saying? But she will pick something like that and have me watch it. Say, oh, ain't that good? Now, what am I supposed to, man, no. I turn that off right now. Didn't I just tell you my boss told me I had to work tomorrow? I'm already mad. This ain't going to help that. So, no Roots tonight. So thank you, Sirius Black. I appreciate you, man. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. So, any more questions about the bees or anything else? Because I'm trying to answer as much stuff as I possibly can. Oh, here's a question. And I know I'm going to be answering this for years. Wait a minute. What can you do with the mother left at the bottom of the apple cider bottle? Anyone know? Add it to more vinegar. You supposed to be drinking that mother at the bottom of the bottle. You ain't supposed to be leaving that at the bottom. That's supposed to be going to your body. Can Lady Led do a canning video? Lady Led? She in a whole nother wing of the house. Do you have a honey harvesting video? I have several. And they, let me tell you something, I'm gonna be honest with you. They turn me on. You know what I'm saying? Some people don't like them. They are boring as hell. I'm not gonna begin to lie to you. They long and they boring. What do people call that? Where people just like to watch people like listen to them, blink their eyes and shit. What is that? And it's in quiet. It's a new word for that. I don't know. It's some letters. ASMR. It's more of ASMR-ish because you can kind of hear me talking, but it's more of watching me spin the honey for 20 minutes. Then you watch gallons of honey pour out through a coffee filter, through a strainer. Then you see the 5-gallon buckets of honey. Then you see me weigh each bucket. Then you see me pouring the honey. So if you into that kind of thing, like I am, it's sexual. Okay? It slowly becomes sexual to me. Because it's beautiful. And everything that it holds, this got life. This is life. Once you taste this, you will know you're doing the right thing by eating this. If you taste this, ain't nothing, you can't, if somebody tell you doing wrong by eating this, they a liar. When you taste it, your whole body know, yep, this is right. This is right. So, I know good and well. You taste that thing right there. I'm going to say this. I don't know about everybody. Fellas, go find some raw honey. Okay? Just saying. I'm not going to say what I'm saying it for. Put it like this. I personally think this can put that one little pill out of business. I'm just saying. Just saying. My own personal opinion. Fellas, just saying. The darker, the stronger. The darker, the stronger. Okay? The darker, the stronger, the darker, the longer. Just saying. Personal opinion. Before you go sitting up in the middle of the night and listen to them like, yes, I had a terrible blood flow. Don't listen to that commercial. Just be like this. Email, Led, I heard what you said about the honey. Do you think you could spare a few ounces for me? Got a hot date in a week. I'm just saying. Okay? I don't want to go down that alley. I'm just going to peek around the dumpster on that one. So, and I mean it. I'm serious. Them just ain't jokes. It's something in this stuff. It's something in here. I'm telling you, all your health, you can feel it. When you feel, okay, when you drink liquor, you feel it working, right? And if you are one that is legally allowed to smoke a little weed, you feel it work. Okay? Well, when you taste this honey, you feel it work. I'm just saying, just like all that other stuff, after a while, you kind of start feeling smooth, right? You start feeling like, yeah, I could dig this. Well, after this, you taste a little of that. You start feeling a little bit more sexy. You know what I'm saying? You might be ugly as a baby toe, but you feel like Denzel with a couple spoonfuls of that. I'm just saying. It's kind of, for everybody, I'm going to just say this. I don't care what you look like. It ain't your looks. It's your confidence. You know what I'm saying? That's confidence is sexy. If you can find somebody to give you that confidence or find something to give you that confidence, make you feel good about yourself, people see you different. If you feel that, you know, and you, how many people out there say, oh, what is she doing with him? Good God. Look at it. Cool. I can't stare at him with both eyes. I got to keep one eye closed when I stare at him. You know. Oh, just one eye. Maybe his confidence is so strong, he hypnotized. Baby, look. You know what I'm saying? Same thing with, you see the dude and women be like, man, he beautiful. What is he doing with that donkey? Maybe her confidence, and she can't tell, you can't tell her she ain't sexy. You can't tell her she ain't her worth. Them people know they worth. And once they show you what I'm worth, that turns people on. You know what I'm saying? And if they probably taste a little bit of that, taste a little bit of this, you know what I'm saying? They feel a little bit more confident about what's going to happen. I'm just saying. So, before I go to Cassie, I told you I done had a little bit of honey. I done had a little bit of lead poison. I'm feeling confident right now. So we gonna stop going down that alley because it ain't time yet. And we've been on here forever. Let me see. Please don't choke on your peanuts. Don't choke on your peanuts. Yeah, she know what's up. Look, let me crack this. I'm going to open this. We're going to taste this together. We're going to taste this crystallized. Ooh. See what I'm saying? You can't buy that at the store. I'm gonna set that down. See, the top is still soft. I'm trying to get to the crystal. You see that? That's the crystal right there. That's the stuff you melt on your tongue. Let it melt on your tongue. Oh. That right there. That's life right there. You know what I'm saying? That is life. Somebody said ASMR. That's life right there. Let that melt on your tongue. Look, remember I was sniffing? Remember I was snotting? See my nose working? Watch this nostril. This nostril, I've been snotting this whole time. Y'all seen it. I took that. Remember how stuffy I was sounding? Both nostrils, baby. Hear that? I can't make this shit up. I should have ate this earlier. That right there is life in a jar. One way to see it, how many lives was lost to make that? All them bees died making honey for you, for them. They only lived 30 days, spend their whole life going back and forth to flowers. In a lifetime, let me show you something. Want to see a honeybee's lifetime? This is a honeybee's lifespan. I know you don't know what that means. What that means is in 30 days, one honeybee only makes one tablespoon of honey. I want you to do the math, okay? One honeybee makes one tablespoon of honey in 30 whole days, spent its life making this. So when you see me with 10, 15, and 20 gallons of honey, how many bees' lives were lost making it? Now, watch this. A bee spent his whole life for me to taste one spoon of honey. I just had to go deep real quick on y'all because that's how I see it. That's why I know what it's worth. That's why I don't give it away unless I really like you. That's why I sell it at the price I sell it at. It's more to it than what people, when they see honey, they think Walmart, Kroger's. Oh, I can get a bottle of that for $5 inside the little bear. And when I'm done with the honey, I got a little bear. I can give it to my baby. It's not honey. No bees spending their life making that. If some dude made that out of corn syrup, put one tablespoon. Here's a rule that y'all need to please Google this. There's videos on this too on Netflix. If you cut corn syrup and only put a couple tablespoons, a couple cups of real raw honey in a 50-gallon drum of corn syrup, they consider that pure raw honey. They ship that from overseas on big shipper tankers to the Americas. Once the Americas found out what they were doing, they said, no, Asia, you cannot ship that over here anymore because we know what you're doing. So what do? They get smart. They still making the crap honey. So they send it over somewhere else. Let's just say Africa, okay? Just for shits and giggles. Then once these tankers go to Africa, that tanker, they unload it, put it on that tanker. Now the tanker is coming from Africa, coming to the Americas, which they have all the right to get in. Now it's legal. Same raggedy honey or fake honey. Different rules, different red tape that they can't stop. So what you're buying in the store is not honey. Even when it says it's 100% pure raw honey, and then the dumbasses put the little comb inside to make you think that you're really doing something. Number one, when I put the comb in the honey, some woman, I tried to talk her out of it. She said, do you got the honey with the comb in it? That's what I remember when I was a kid. I said, yeah, but you don't really want to do that because it takes up space and it just wastes, you don't get as much honey. Yeah, but that's what I used to have when I was a kid. But ma'am, do you sure you want that? Because I'm giving you less honey, put the comb in it. I said, okay. For some reason, we are nostalgic on everything. We think everything, every year you're supposed to put a Christmas tree up and you're supposed to decorate it with a bunch of lights, burn your damn house down. You stuff the kitchen full of food on the table for no apparent reason when other people is walking down the street hungry. You and your babies and your family in here eating a bunch of food that ain't nobody gonna eat because 75% of that shit gonna go into the trash can. But then you're gonna beat the bum up just picking in the trash can because he just want a plate to eat. We too hyped on tradition. Tradition, number one, that come from evil. Some of this shit is evil. And some of the traditions is damn ridiculous. We too caught up on traditional ways of thinking instead of thinking logically. You understand? Because for the life of me, can't nobody explain that Easter Bunny. Explain that bunny rabbit to me. And frankly, I'm glad because I don't want to hear that shit. He ain't got nothing to do with nothing. What that bunny rabbit got to do with anything? Listen close. Okay, this ain't even about the religious part of it. Before you get to the religious part of it, okay, this Easter bunny is laying eggs. Bunny is laying eggs. All of that's demonic. It's cute, but it's demonic as hell to me. So since I was a kid, I used to tell people, please explain to me, you know, where the egg come out of? Is a certain bunny rabbit supposed to happen? I got to put out of school for that one time, you know, when I was a kid. When you know, you go up to the teacher, and the teacher says, okay, what is this? It's a duck. What sound do a duck make? Quack, quack. You know, what do the bird do? It fly. What do the bunny do? My dumb ass, it lay eggs. Go to the back of class. Go to the principal office. I'm getting in trouble. I'm getting in trouble. But nobody explained it to me. Okay, dig it. To this day, this is how our culture is, okay? You've been telling me a lie my whole life. But then when you tell me at school, what sound do a duck make? Quack, quack. What do a dog do? Bark, bark. What do a bird do? It fly. What do a bunny rabbit do? It lay eggs. And now you tell me I'm a class clown, I'm a cut up, and I got a whooping for that shit. You know what I'm saying? Y'all confusing me. That's what's wrong with the kids today. We confused. You got to stop that nonsense. Some of these storybooks go too far. Okay? You know? And I'm sorry. I went off on a tangent. But some of this stuff is nonsense. And that's why we got to start educating ourselves with reality. So the only reason I keep telling y'all this kind of stuff with beekeeping, gardening, self-sufficiency is because it all just tastes like the truth. It tastes realistic. It don't make you think. Get this. Gardening is something that you don't really have to think about. It feels natural. When you eat honey and taste it, it tastes like you're supposed to be eating it. When you eat a cookie, you feel like you just murdered somebody and hid the body, you know, and only you know where the body at. You got the crime, the weapon hid. That's how you feel when you eat cookies and cakes and pies and shit, right? But when you eat something, this, how can you be mad at yourself for eating this? Mother Nature made this. God made this. You can't be mad. Now, if you sit down and eat a whole jar of this shit, now, you might have a problem. But I'm just saying, it tastes like you're supposed to be eating it. Don't need too many explanations. Put the seed in the dirt, plant come up, the plant let off fruit, you eat the fruit, you feel better. That don't take a whole bunch of explanation of why do I feel better? No, it just feel like it's just supposed to be this way. So, that's all I'm saying. Anyway, I'm sorry. And I went off on a tangent. I tried to answer as many questions as I could. Yes, cookies, cakes, and pies. You know you feel bad after you eat one of them. You eat some cookies, cakes, and pies. You know what she said the other day? She said, you know, I pass gas. And she said, oh, what you been eating? She knew. Even your bowel movements, your gas, everything else, don't smell right. It don't function right. Your bowels don't function right. But when you eating stuff like this and stuff supposed to be in your body, it seems like just everything just work. You feel better. Go to work. You can breathe. You know that. When you exercise, you feel better. When you do stuff that's right for your body and right for your spirit and right for your mind, nobody has to tell you what you're doing is right or wrong. It just feels right. Like when you fall in love. You know what I'm saying? You know what feel right. You know when you met this dude and his pants was hanging down, you know you're going to have some problems. He making bad wardrobe decisions before y'all even make financial decisions. So right there, you know what you was getting yourself into. Okay? So you knew. But when you something just feel right, it don't feel forced. It don't feel like you gotta keep pretending to be something you not. He telling you he done passed gas as long as he said, excuse me. You know, you don't feel bad about telling him he got something in his nose. You really don't want him, nobody else to see. You want it just feel like it's supposed to be that's the one that's going to hurt. That's the one that's going to work out. You know, not that forced, fake, phony shit that people do. Everybody, either you want to be a rap star, you want to be a inner fake singer. I don't know. Everybody enter these relationships like that. Then find out the real you. You can't keep that act up for long. Coco Mitchell said, I want some honey, please. Me too. I could go for some more right now. Cheryl's Organic Food Foods. Hey, Bull. Bull is in the house. What's up, Bull? Be Wild. Thank you so much, Be Wild. Guava to you. Thank you so much. So, if you want to know how to catch bees, the reason that was so quick, because that's that simple. Oh, for let me tell you something else. I know this is a long video, but I miss y'all, and I don't know how long the Wi-Fi was going to hold out. Here's something. One more piece of knowledge. I wish everybody was still in the house because I want to give them one more piece. Fast forward to this for people and let them see this because this is true. One of our businesses that we do, once you get into beekeeping, you want to know how to make easy money? Who want to know how to make easy money once you become a beekeeper? Good. Some more people came back in the house. Good, good. Who want to know how to make extra money? Good money. Okay. What when you learn how to do be Stardust say Led, thank you. Thank you so much, Stardust. Lady Led Liz, mom bless. Thank you so much. Okay. Everybody wanna know how to make extra money. I'm gonna tell you. And I'm gonna put that video in this link too. If you've been to our website to buy the honey, or if you've been to the website to buy the t-shirts, you also see there's another hotline that me and Lady Led do. And we've been doing this for years. Number one, she's a queen breeder. So people come to us when they need queens. Your queen might die. You might crush the queen. If you crush the queen, they can't make another one. But it depends, okay? If you need an emergency queen, we make our own queens. That's pushing it. Don't worry about that too soon, okay? I don't get into the queen breeding. That's her little hobby pet peeve, and it's awesome. I don't know how she do it. It's here's the other thing, how we make free money. Forget that. This is how. Once you start keeping bees and realize how simple it is. Y'all saw in the thumbnail I had this little flimsy thing on that I got off the line. I keep one of these in my truck all the time. Not my whole suit, just this. You know why? Because when I'm at work, if I see a swarm, I get it. I tape it up and bring it home and I sell it. Cha-ching. A nuke comes with a queen, a hive full of honey, because each bee got honey in their belly. As soon as they get in a box, they start building wax fast, like in a day. And that whole little cardboard box, if you don't hurry up and get it out, it's going to be loaded with honey, babies, queen, eggs, everything. A nuke can be sold from about $250. Stay with me. So, if somebody say, hey, Led, I see some bees. I go, what we do on the website, people call us all year long. Me and Lady Led, sometimes she called me at work like, we got two bee calls. Ugh, I'm hot, I'm tired, I just want to go home, go to sleep. But I tell them, how serious is it? They want them gone off their porch right now. They at a wedding, they want them now. So, okay. We do it for free. Unless I'm unable to. If I have to cut out of my time to come get it, I have to charge. I don't break your neck. But it's $100 for every step that I go up on a ladder. I'm too big to be on a ladder. You know what I'm saying? If I fall, break my body up, hospital bills. So, just say people will pay me $200 to $300 to get the bees from their house. And 15 minutes, and I've done it in 5. I got plenty of those videos too. They old, but you got to look at them. I was training my nephews, so it's a lot of cursing in that one because they holding the camera. A lady say, listen, I got bees on my porch, bees in my bushes. What me and Lady Led do? We go out with a box. The bees are in a bundle, and you've probably seen it, sitting in a bush or on their porch. We shake the bush, knock them down in the box, Try to look for the queen, but if you can't find the queen, you watch them. If they all start going in the box, let me turn it around. That means you got the queen in the box because they smell her. So you leave that hole open, put the lid on, and in about 5 to 10 minutes, depending on how big the swarm is, they'll all go in the box. You put some tape over the hole and go home. Now you just made $200 for the people that paid you to get them off their house. And now you go and sell it for $250. We've made $500 in less than 30 minutes or many a day. This ain't nothing I want to keep to myself. I'm just giving you some straight game. So if you don't like bees, you like them now. Once you start making more money during bee swarm season than you make at your good job, oh, trust and believe, it's many a time I made more money with my bee operation than I have at my job. Y'all know where I work. Plenty of times. It's that easy. And now, what I always like to do is prove it. I have videos of me doing bee calls. Lady Leg got a couple videos of her doing bee calls. She saved some on late last summer on a playground, a children's playground, off somebody's swing set. Free money. You get those bees, either you can keep them for yourself and let them make money for you and sell the honey, sell the wax, or you could turn around and put them in a box that you just don't want to, you know, put them in a box like this, put some frames in it, let them go to work, and then sell this whole box for $250, $300, depending on what time of season it is. People get desperate for this, just like Christmas time. People running out of toys, they'll buy anything. They start going to the dollar store after a while, right? Buying that Barbie doll with one arm and shit. People get desperate. No different during bee season. They need a queen. Oh, their hive gonna fail. Oh, I've had this hive for 20 years. I can't let it fail. They'll pay anything for that queen. Same thing with hive. Okay? Free game, free money. Once you know how to do this and see how, I ain't gonna say it's easy because it's not. It's, you need patience. Because it's easy if you patient, and y'all know I'm not very patient. I like to move fast, get stuff over with. Lady Led is the patient one. And trust me, she do a lot of work in the hives because I don't be moving like I'm doing, you know, feng shui and stuff. I don't move like that. That's her. She moves like a swan. I move like a one-legged duck. I'm ready to hurry up and get stuff over with. So, if you smooth and you can take your time, you got that hot ass suit on and it's 98 degrees outside, you start to smell yourself fast. I don't care how much deodorant you got on. Matter of fact, that's another tip. Don't touch no hive if you got on perfume, deodorant, a strong soap. Think about this. Everybody say, what kind of soap you put on your trees to keep pests away? Right? That green soap, don't go out there with that on. Don't go in that hive with that on. And that's one of my favorites. Don't go in there with that. They instantly gonna start hitting your face mask like this. They smell you smelling Irish fresh. And they don't like that shit. You know what I'm saying? They don't like that. And they gonna show you. And you gonna learn real quick. When we go out to the hive, go before you get in the shower. If you already smelling like a dumpster, that's the time to go. When you got your own pheromones coming off you and you smell like you do anything for a nickel, that's when you go to the hive. Don't go out there after a fresh shower. Like, I'm going to just hit the shower first and I'm going to go to the hive. Don't do that. You piss them off. The same things that soap and all the fragrances do in your garden to repel pests and insects, they're insects. You gotta use your head. You piss them off. Now imagine, you ain't repelling them, that smell is coming into their house. You just crack their roof off, tore off their roof like a tornado, and now you smell Irish Fresh. Pissing them off, man. You can't do that to people. You know what I'm saying? You can't do that. So you got to think about how this works. It's little subtle things. You don't need a whole bunch of smoke. You don't use a smoker. Just sit there like you're trying to do a damn 10-alarm fire. No, no, no. You see how I do it? Wave that smoke around. Spread it on yourself. I do it like perfume. Remember the ladies had a little bottle? Smoke yourself. Go smoke yourself. Smoke around the area. Don't be pumping that smoke. I taught this guy. I mentored this guy. He was a neighbor of mine. How to be a beekeeper. He's a beekeeper to this day. His very first honey harvest tasted like damn saddlewood barbecue. I said, man, he said, man, thank you for everything. I'm going to give you my first jar of honey, man. Thank you. Oh, my God, thank you. He got about 3 gallons. I said, bruh, what you do? Man, I was too scared to go in there, man. I started smoking them, man. I smoked the hell out of them. This is so dense that it sucks up. This is kind of like a baking soda. Right? That's why you keep it in glass jars, not plastic, not all that other weird stuff. You always see honey in glass. Real honey is in glass. You know why? Because it absorbs flavors and odors like a sponge because it's so dense. There's no water in it. There's no liquid in it. It's pure concentrated life, pure concentrated nectar. So it's just aiming for some water. So if it does touch something, that's when the mold set in because it wants that moisture. So if you smoke your damn hive, you just ruined 5 to 10 to 15 gallons of honey. And guess what? The bees don't even want that back either because they hate the smell of smoke. It's just a waste. So I told him, he said, what am I going to do with all this honey? You better make that into some good barbecue sauce because that's all it's going to be good for. I got that honey to this day. I got another guy that I mentored at my job. His honey is up there. And you don't want to know why I don't eat his honey? I got his honey. Won't touch it. Because he started, after I mentored him and I told him I don't do all that fancy stuff to my beehives, he started doing, oh, I use this crystallite in there and I use this. I tasted, he said, taste it. I tasted it one time and could taste every damn chemical he put in that hive. I got it up there as a trophy to show I showed him how to do it. I won't eat that shit though, and I won't tell nobody, don't go to him. And I told him that. He probably watching me now. You know, man, how I feel about that. Don't do it. Don't do it. You might as well go to Walmart and get the shit. If you're going to pump all that garbage in it, you know. I've been on here way too long. I'm having too much fun, Charlie Murphy. I'm sorry, y'all. Thank you for hanging out with me this long. God, I've been, and thank for everybody that donated and this chat things. Okay. Good question. See, I wanted to get off somebody, hit me with a good one. Do you need a queen divider? I do not use them. I hate them. Again. Natural. If that queen wants to go up into the honey box at the top and lay eggs, you just ain't gonna have no honey. Let her go wherever she want and do whatever she want to do in her kingdom. If she feel that you're worthy to have a whole box of honey all at the top, that's her blessing you. But if she tell you, I need that room for my babies, just be like, back off. And I'm going to tell you this, just to keep you motivated. Your first year, you might not get no honey. I always tell everybody that. It's never true. But you might not. It's never true. But you might not. Don't go in there looking for honey or you're going to be disappointed. If that queen want to lay up there, it's honey on both sides, but it's a bunch of babies in the middle. Number one... Swarm season is now, somebody just asked. When is swarm season now down here in South Carolina? Do you make mead from your honey? No, I kind of think that's kind of like a waste a little bit. I wouldn't use all that just to make no wine. It's that stuff is just too pure and too rich. Now, I back sweetened this, the lead poison, with a little bit of honey because it was dry wine at first. Now it's sweet from this. So it tastes like my honey, but it made me sweat out the forehead a little bit. Let me see. Woo, a lot of questions. Make a B setup video ASAP. You know what? I will. I can do that. I'm buffering. Where is the King B? There is no King B. Let me tell you something about life. When you learn how to keep bees, it's going to teach you something about humanity. Game nurse said, I'm in Toledo. Do I still have time unless swarm season here? You got plenty of time in Toledo. You got to wait till at least June. April or May or June. May or June. You got plenty of time. There is no King B. I ain't going to get into my beliefs. I'm just going to explain a beehive to you. Maybe this will help some of y'all in y'all lives where some of you ladies feel so weak. I'm going to just say this. So stick with me. Stick with me. Don't throw rocks at me. In a beehive, there is only females. All honeybees are females. Stick with me, please. Don't hate me for this. All the honeybees are females. And then there's the queen. They cater to the queen, her every whim. Her only job in life is to lay eggs. She don't got to go hunt for food. They bring her food. She don't got to stay clean. She constantly got a bunch of them around her, cleaning her, grooming her, taking care of the eggs as they come out, feeding her constantly. Okay? Now, when the queen and the rest of the hive feels it's swarm season, it's time to spread our DNA because you can't keep inbreeding, right? The queen says, okay, it's time to make some men. Stick with me on this, okay? This is when you learn this, it's like humans. It's the truth. And I've explained this to my daughter many a day with my situations. Stay with me. So when the queen say it's time to make some men so we can spread our DNA to repopulate the earth, she make a handful of what they call drones, male bees. The only thing this man bee does is to mate with another queen from another hive. It's only one queen in every hive. Well, that's not true. Sometimes it's two, but that's rare. One queen in every hive. But she let off about 100 or so drones, male bees. All these 100 drones is after one queen bee. Okay? Stick with me. So one male bee or several male bees can mate with that queen bee, which she will lay eggs for the rest of her life off of the packages they left her. Okay? So just say she got about four or five, she had a nice freaky night. Four or five drones got to her. Stay with me. In the meantime, that queen she's pollinated, she's ready to start laying eggs. In the meantime, what do this other 100 and something male bees do? They sit around the house, eating up all the food. You know what I'm saying? Every time I go to the refrigerator, you in the refrigerator. Eating up all the honey. Taking up all the space. Male drones don't have stingers. Because their only job is to mate with another queen. Stay with me. So in the meantime, they're in there eating up all the honey. Eating up all the food. Taking up too much space, making the hive hot and messy. They in there pooping. All the other female honeybees cleaning up after the man, because he in there making a mess. It's 100 of them. They making a mess. They taking up space. They stepping on the baby's head, stepping on the baby toys and shit. They messing up. After a while, they say, that's enough. The queen in that house said, that's enough. I'm tired of you, Frank. I'm tired of this shit. I can't live like this no more. You know what I'm saying? I can't live like this no more. I'm better than this, Frank. So what do? All of, she ordered all of the lady bees, because men ain't shit in that hive. I'm going to keep it real. This, okay? If you ain't shit, after a while, you useless. You eating up all my food. We working hard. Come home. You done made the house messy. I'm cleaning up after your ass. Tired of. They bite his wing off. Bite off either both or one of his wings. And throw his ass literally drag him out the front door, and they bite his wing off so he can't fly back into the hive. And every blue moon, you see hundreds of drone big fat bees down there, bellies full and stanking in the front of the hive. You wonder what's wrong. No, they got tired of him. Frank, that's enough, Frank. That's enough. I'm the only one in here working, Frank. Now, you can take that to some scripture if you want to. Man don't work, don't eat, right? Just saying. You in here eating up all the cornbread. Eating up all the hog moths. He ain't doing nothing. He don't got no stinger because he can't even defend himself. So he weak. He's sorry. So he's so sorry he can't defend himself from the little. Look. A drone is about that big. Okay, it look like one of them carpenter bees, big fat bees to drill holes in your house. Little honeybee is like this. And about three of them gang up on him, be like, girl, help me get him out. Girl, look, I'm on my way. I'm on my way. What'd he do? What'd he say? I'm on my way. Same thing with us humans we do. You get tired of people, it's time for them to go. You finally get up the courage to put them out. It's no different, okay? If he gonna be sorry, if he helping while he was helping and he was out there spreading DNA for our survival, being a man, it was the girl bee, the honey bee's job to feed him, to clean him, to cater to him, to take care of him, go back to, okay? If you want to get religious with it, that was her king at the time. They treated him, all the male bees, like they treated the queen. They fed him. He don't got to hunt for food. It's their job to feed him. It's their job to clean up after him. It's their job to cater to him. You can go into the scriptures on that if you want to, okay? I ain't messing with it. Just saying. But after a while, when you ain't doing what you're supposed to be doing, man, you got to go. You know, the baby's hungry. You done ate the baby food. You done ate up all the food, man. Really? Really? What is he supposed to eat?
I thought you had him some food. I just kind of thought this was in the refrigerator for me.
It's a Gerber's, fool. That don't got nothing to do with you. Bees, once you start beekeeping, you're going to see how much humanity goes on in that hive. How they communicate, they literally are talking, and you get a chance to decipher what they're saying to each other. Not from no, you know, freak. I'm talking about they have mathematical directions that they go to tell each other where to go. And they do what they call is the waggle dance, a bee dance on the front of the hive or inside the hive, and the other bees is following them like, okay, left at the tree, okay, make a right at the fire hydrant, okay, make another right at the big dog on the chain, okay, and stop by the red Dodge Challenger. And there's some trees right there we need to go to. Scientists have proven They're talking, and once they realize they're really saying real words and follow everything that that waggle dance did, they found the same bee that was doing it and showed the rest of them. I can't make this up. Google it. So something that intelligent, they're not just doing their little antennas like they do on cartoons and stuff. No, they on the front of the box talking. And if you watch your beehives like we do all day, I shit you not, we sit right here. I can't make this up. Look at this. We sit right here and watch the hive. Sometime I zoom my camera in on it and I got hours of footage. It's amazing. Jacques Cousteau would be like, boy, you's a bad boy. If he knew, tell him. Damn, I'm tangled up. So, watching them, you start seeing some too much humanity to go on inside that hive. Then you start identifying the bees, the sizes, the colors, it's different sizes, shapes, and colors of them, and you start identifying them. Like you would, like, to me, two chihuahuas look like two chihuahuas. But if you're a dog lover, you know good and well, them is two entirely different dogs, right? It'll blow your mind. It'll blow your mind. I've been on here forever. I told you, I get too passionate about this. This is why I wanted to do a video and not a live on it. I'm going to do a video and just show you just step by step. By step, instead of y'all having to come in here and listen to me babble on. I'm sorry. I do get passionate about it because it's amazing. Is this still live? Yeah, it's still live. I'm still on. I'm about to stop now. When is swarm season in Georgia? Right now. Swarm season is coming up in the next 30 days, not from now until. Lord, I said, like the babbling. Thank you, but I'm sorry for that. I get too passionate about that. And then I will, me and Lady Led talk about it all day because it's amazing. Where can I get honey? I don't know. I don't have any right now. Same in Florida. Yes, same in Florida for swarm season. What is your website? easilygrowngarden@yahoo.com. I'll put it in the link below. I think a drone got free from the workers because he tried to attack me. I had to swat him. No, that wasn't a drone. That was a carpenter bee. A drone ain't gonna do nothing. They make a lot of noise like, bah. He even sound lazy, you know, boom. And, somebody earlier, I seen it, it went past it. What scripture? I told you I ain't gonna mess with that. Don't do that to me, okay? Wrong guy, wrong channel. Let me see. To me, okay. Let me see with that. Don't apologize. Awesome information. Thank you. And I'm gonna tell you something about keeping bees. As long as this video is, that's kind of like beekeeping. It's so much to it that you kind of don't, every word leads you to another part of it. So I kind of don't want to leave a lot out, which I did, because you could talk about it forever. It's so much to it. But it's simple as long as you move slow. As easy as I told you how to bait that hive, that's how simple it is. I will post the website. Looking for instructional video. Yeah, I'm going to make the video short and sweet. As a matter of fact, I know poor Frank, but Frank was eating up the baby food. You know what I'm saying? I mean, he's a good guy. I like him. But eating the baby food, he crossed the line. So let me see. Do you need certain smoke? No, I like to use, you know, the wood chip bedding for you for hamsters and stuff like that. Pine straw and pine chip bedding, a pair of old drawers. I know that sounds crazy, some old jeans, because it burns slow and it smokes hard. But trust me, we done used some old drawers, old pairs of jeans, old socks, because that cotton burns slow. Let me see. You just knocked the bees down. From what, out the tree? Pretty much, yeah. I will grab a limb with the bees on it, put the box underneath and a tarp, and shake them. When they all hit the ground, if you got this baited up with some of that bait that I told you about, they will go in there like magic. Do me a favor. You don't have to watch this whole long video again. I just missed y'all, and I like having y'all around. We was talking together. No, egg cartons ain't going to work. What you mean? The box of egg cartons? Any kind of box. Big cardboard box, like a banana boxes and stuff like that. So that stuff really helps. What time is it, baby? Is it time? I ain't know it was that long. I'm having fun. We talk about B. Yeah, I'm having fun, baby. Okay, I'm right behind you. I done told him about some of the, I done told him about what this honey do, girl.
Get this off my computer, though.
Oh, I'm sorry. Don't beat me, Hoppo. I done told him about this honey.
Yeah, that's
mine. What'd you say? This yours.
It's mine. 528 is mine.
Look what this one is. Oh, you said 528?
And
630.
Both of them is mine.
We date them from when we harvested, yes. So we know what different taste they be.
It's mine.
You need a hit? I'm hurting, baby. She said, I need a dose. I'm hurting, baby. Come on, man. Don't do this to me. Look, okay. No, I'm not in trouble. Good day, sir. So, yeah. Does the bees stay alive during off season? Is there a special place to store bees? You don't store bees. Think like this. You're putting them in a box. What do they do in the wild? You don't do nothing. Once you start messing with, they know how to keep the hive hot. They know how to cool the hive off. Once you start doing crazy stuff to the bees, unless bees is somewhere like in New York where it's heavy snow, cold for 8 months, that's different. But if you ain't, you live somewhere kind of with a milder climate, leave them alone. You're going to kill them because you're going to overheat them. You're going to overcook them. I did that once. I ain't going to lie to you. You know those covers you put over a Weber grill? They fit perfectly over a stack of bee boxes, perfectly over a hive. Here's the problem with that. I wanted them to be warm, and it was a cold winter. That winter here down in South Carolina, we had iced over and everything else. Listen to this. Put that Weber grill thing on there. Luckily, I didn't work that day. I seen all them bees flying out of that hive. It was ice out. But the bees is coming out like, what the hell? That's because that black Weber grill cover, the black absorbing the heat from the sun, was cooking them. I cooked my bees fast too. Once I felt the box inside, the box was hot. Literally, you know. So, don't just leave them alone. The more stuff you do to them, you just gonna screw them up. You just leave them alone. If you live down here in the South or a more milder climate, like, you know, Kentucky on down, leave them alone. Leave them alone. You waste a lot of money. You killed a lot of bees. You gonna feel terrible, you know. So that's how it works. So, let me see. I missed something. See, waste time on seeing our videos. was turned. Okay, I don't know who that was. But thank you, Nick. I just caught that. you and Queen Lee are too sweet. That's my baby. She know I be messing with her. So, yeah, we've been out of honey for a long time, since late last summer. We ran out fast. All those gallons of honey went like that. I gave a lot away for gifts. I sold a lot. And, you know, we need some for our next set of bees. And we kept some for ourselves for, you know, preparedness. Rubbermaid container. No. I'm going to tell you why. People have done it. But here's the thing about a Rubbermaid bucket. Try to use cardboard or wood. When you use plastic to either catch bees or try to do a beehive, plastic heats up in the sun real fast. Remember, bees is going to be in the sun all day. You go put a plate of food in a black Rubbermaid or a gray Rubbermaid bucket and set it in the sun for an hour and come out and watch your food be heated up. Bees, you just cook the bees like you just cooked that plate of food. How you doing, Nancy Cole? Hey, Kira, Mommy of Five. It's good to see you here. Homestead Heart, you have done a step-by-step on how to build the hive bodies from scratch. I have never done a step-by-step, but I did pictures back in the day when I built it. So I'm going to post the pictures and just do a quick, I don't know, a quick, what you call them, little film to show you my steps of how I built it. And I might do a little voiceover to show you how I did it. Because some of it you ain't going to kind of get, because I didn't get every picture. But I'm going to dig that stuff up for you. Just do a quick video. But I'm telling you, it's worth it. If you have land or you own your home, even if you rent, you can do this with your rent. If you got a little bit of space, like the 4x4 patio garden, next to that should be a beehive. You don't take up no space. Next thing you know, and it ain't what you think, like bees just gonna be just humming around, messing with people, walking up, the mailman and stuff. It don't work that way. They out, they in. They just don't be humming around like flies on turds. They don't do that. I don't know anyone in my neck of the woods do their own keeping. You can change that. And you can be that person in your neck of the woods being the beekeeper for your community. That's kind of what I'm trying to do. I want everybody to do it. Let me see. Led, I just got a hive. Now I have to get bees and it will be my first. Please email me and keep me in touch. Please, please. I help you through everything the best I can. Hold on. Must need some more honey. Baby, I tasted some of that crystallized honey. Open my sinuses up for about an hour. Now I'm going back down. I'm making my jelly tomorrow. Goddess said, Goddess Leo. Just kicking it down under. Do you need anything if you live in a super hot climate all year? Nope. Because like I said, if the hive is hot, they know how to cool it off. If the hive is cold, they know how to warm it up. Don't be doing too much extra stuff. Just make sure your hive is ventilated, like it got the bottom hole, and make sure it got a screen under bottom so that air can come up through the hive and help vent them out, okay? That helps them. Hey, Nancy Cole, I didn't see you, but I see Homestead Heart just say hey to you, so I can't find you, but hello, how you doing? Let me see. I don't know that. Somebody's garden, Chulahoma's garden. I got my hive waiting on bees as well. Amen to that. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I like to see. Let me see. I wish I had time to do it. Maybe once I retire. Yes, you do, Miss Craft. You got time. Breezely Highland Farmer, do you plant any wildflowers for your bees? Echinacea, coneflowers, and sunflowers. They love sunflowers. Loving Life Houston, first time catching you live. Thank you, Loving Life Houston. Blessings from Zone 9A family, Nola. Yes, thanks for introducing us to New Orleans Gardener, aka that's my girl. Yeah, she got a good channel over there. Hello, Greenhouse Lounge. Hello, True Airy Organic Farms. Dimples Deep One, I love the Northern Michigan. Oh, I live in Northern Michigan. I am, no you ain't, S out of luck. It ain't too late. I'm from Toledo, Ohio, so I know exactly what you're dealing with. You okay, it ain't too late for you. No excuses. Tell me to get bees from a local source. Right, Lady Leia said, get bees from a local source. Don't get them from down here. Because they'll be already acclimated to your area, okay? Green Organic Love said, I still have fig and apple jelly from last year harvest. I'm excited watching Homestead Heart. Homestead Heart, look, you probably came in late. You see what you made me do? I told y'all, I be watching y'all. I'm driving a raggedy truck. And I can't take my hands off the wheels. I watches all y'all videos all day. I thumb you up and I keep it moving. Homestead Heart, look. I showed him this early in the video. Didn't I tell you? I said, she done put a fire under me. I'm about to start. And now listen to me. Lady Led know how to can. Lady Led know how to pressure can. Lady Led know how to hot water bath can. I don't. So between you, Miss Cheryl's Organic Food Forest, and Lady Led, y'all gonna teach me how to can. It's like I know how to do it, I just never done it. It's like everybody say, I know how to garden, I just never done it. So this is proof to you guys, if you don't just try it, you ain't gonna never know nothing. If you don't get up and try it, you ain't gonna never know. So I'm gonna show you, I didn't know how to make wine. My brother showed me, and I tried it. Now look. Guava, right? I didn't know how to take cuttings. Rosie 5150 showed me how. Now look, if you don't try, you ain't gonna know jack. So try it. Yes, this is intimidating. And the way she was doing it was scaring me with the pressure, pop my head off something. But you know what? She made it look so simple. She didn't get all into those crazy words. She said, make sure your pressure is this now. Check your elevation, because your elevation make a good difference, a big difference. Check your elevation before you go mess around with this thing. Now, this is how you do it. Don't put the steam. Let the lid off this way, because the steam be done burnt your beard off. Homestead Heart, you didn't say burn your beard off. That's just what I heard. You know what I'm saying? Because my dumb ass would be like, psh, you know. Had a perm in here or something. That's what I heard. So I was like, yeah, that's smart. I don't want to burn my face, you know. She made it simple. I watched that whole video like 3 times. I watched the one when you damn even did the candy and sealed the candy in the damn jar. I said, every day I've been watching it. Homestead Heart got me like this. I'm watching Lady Cheryl's Organic Food Forest canning tomatoes, potatoes, and beans and shit. And Homestead Heart pressure cooking red potatoes. And she said something that was so dope. She said, I don't blanch my potatoes first because they turn into mashed potatoes. I've had some before. And I said, you know what? That's probably what happened when the person gave me the potato. They taste like mush. You know, they was mush. Then I've had potatoes. They taste like damn potatoes when you get them out the jar. Well, maybe one person blanched them, one person didn't. So Homestead Heart knew what she was talking about. She said, if you see a little piece like that, cut that out. Cut that out. I watched you. I watches y'all. So don't ever think that I'm somebody all high and mighty or something. I watch everybody. I just ain't got the kind of job where I could just go to typing. And somebody, some questions, I can't answer all of them. It's thousands of them. So please don't feel left out. And I'm not ignoring you. I just can't answer like 3,000 questions because they come in like that every day. I have thousands I can't answer. I'll probably never even find them. And I'm sorry about that. Do each box have a bottom when... Where did that go? Damn, I lost. Oh, when it's stacked on... No. I left it outside. Each box is just a shell, a box like this. No bottom. It's just an empty square like this.
No bottom and no top.
No bottom and no top. Do me a favor. Do me a favor so you get an idea of how much this costs if you start a Langstroth hive. That's the square boxes like this, not the long African top bar. Go on like something like Amazon and look at one box with a top, 10 frames, and a bottom board and see how much it costs. How much did you say that ran? They had a sale like one something? Like 130-ish. It should, that's a good starter. But you got to keep putting more boxes on, more frames. Frames don't cost nothing. Each frame is like $1 or 75 cents, something like that. So, yeah, 125-ish, 130-ish, depending on where you get it. You know, you might catch a sale. But here's what I need people to understand. Once you invest, because it's an investment, once you invest, Homestead Heart said, hey, Lady Led. She said, good night. She up the steps, crunching up the steps. It's an investment. Once you invest, you, number one, help save the world. Number two, you're going to get honey, whether you want it or not. Number three, you learn a skill that you need for times like right now. Because look, I have plenty of this, and it's keeping us healthy, right? You're also learning a skill that's going to make you more money, either mentoring somebody else, because that costs money, that's your time, mentoring, going to do bee calls, taking bees off people's house, that's making money, turn around and sell the nuke full of bees, that's more money, okay? It's, you learned a skill, not only just saving your life, saving the world, pollinating your garden, but you also bringing in income, a normal, good, healthy, legal income. All while saving the world. That's some Superman shit, you ask me, you know? So, let me see. Usually can't reseal a jar. Okay, I that's not a question for me. Just kick it on down under. I totally love Living Farmer 73 and Homestead Heart. Huge hug. Thank you so much. We appreciate it, I'm sure. Yes, Nick Thomas, investment in caps. Gardening, beekeeping, don't ever forget that. Don't ever forget it because you can't. It's just truth. It ain't nothing you got to read. All you got to do it is do it, and it's going to prove it to you. This ain't something somebody told you, and you got to go off their word. If you do it, it's going to prove it to you for you. Thank you, Felicia. I appreciate that. Yeah, she ain't too bad. Four Horse Farm, good to see you in here. How you doing tonight? Let me see. Trash says, diversify income while saving the world. That's right. I got a cape on blowing in back of me. How much space is needed for a beehive? A beehive, that's a perfect question. This, I don't know what she did with my tape measure. That's about a foot and a half long. Okay? Back up. Foot and a half long. Foot and a half, about 16 inches long, 16 inches wide. Okay? And about, I forget what it is, like 8 inches deep. That's the space it's going to take up in a square like this. Straight up and down. This ain't like Legos. This only goes straight up and down. So that square is the space that you're going to take up. As big as just say your torso. No space at all. I literally, and you can watch my videos. I got a playlist of beehives. I literally have a beehive on my back porch, my front porch, and by my garage door. Take up no space. No space. So just say 2 feet by 2 feet. If that, not even that. Let me see. Hey, Diva Jones. I'm just seeing people say hey to you. I can't see you. How do you know when you have to add another hive? Because that box will be packed full of bees. So when that box, that first box is packed full of bees, you don't want to go too, like, add a bunch of boxes at once, because that let pests hang out just like your house. If you got a big giant house, it's only two people living in, you can have rats in the attic, not even know, right? Okay, same thing with a beehive. Once that first box is full of bees, you can see how jam-packed it be. Full of babies, full of eggs, full of bees, full of honey. Add another box. Take some of those frames that's already full of stuff, honey, eggs, larvae, take those and put them in the box up on top of that and add other frames with it. They'll come right up there and fill them right up too. Once that box is full, you repeat. Keep doing that over and over and over again. After a while, they know they usually only go up maybe two deep boxes. I like to use deep frame boxes. After that, anything over those two is all honey. So if you got three boxes over those two, usually that's all honey. And you, when you see me struggling in those videos trying to pick the boxes up and I use a dolly, a hand truck, it ain't because I'm weak, because I ain't. Each one of them suckers is about 50 to 100 pounds of honey. You ain't picking that up. So you see me only picking up one box at a time and I put it on a hand truck. You'll see. This ain't about being macho. Once you see how heavy that shit is, go ahead and pull your backbone out, make you poop your pants trying to pick up that box. Now, mind you, you still got bees humming around your head because you just stole their honey. It ain't like you just trying to lift some weights in the gym. You picking up a box full of their food. You just robbed them, literally. You got to just be cool. Question. When do you know when it's time to extract the honey? Because remember I told you those first two boxes, once they full of bees and honey, and now the rest of those boxes start getting full with honey that you added? You got to take the honey out. Everybody say, oh, I just want to save the bees. I just don't want to take their honey. That's robbing them. If you don't rob them, this is what they're going to do. Just like you, your house is full of damn people. Look, it's too many people in this house. It's packed. It's dirty. It's crowded. Let's go. You got too much food in here. If you don't take that honey out, the bees will leave. The bees will swarm. They'll split. And half of the box will leave and just leave. Sometimes the whole box will leave. So to trick them into thinking that it's more space, they have plenty of space to keep making bees and honey, take that box of bees. Now you separate your hive. You take that bees. That's another subject altogether. Now you went from one hive to two hives. You take that old queen. They're going to make a queen cell. You leave that queen cell in that old box, take the queen, put her in the new box, two hives. They hatching out a whole brand new queen over here. Now you got two hives and they're going to do the same thing. Two hives turn into four hives, four turn into eight, so on and so forth. That's where all this beekeeping I got started from one package of bees. Angela's Busy Bee Garden, what was the question? I missed it. I see that. Angela's Garden Sense, I think. Angela's Garden Sense. What's the question, Angela? I missed it. Repeat it for me, either Green Organic Love or Angela. Oh, question. When do you know when to extract the honey? Okay, yeah. That's when. It's kind of like you gotta monitor your bees. And once you start seeing them packing up and they ain't really flying out no more, they ain't really going to work, because they feel once that hive is full of honey and full of bees, they kind of like, even if we go to work, we ain't got nowhere to bring the groceries to. So we ain't going to work. So let's move out. That's how they think. we need to move on. Here's the bad part. When they leave, they take their groceries with them. They empty the hive from honey and they leave. So you will open up a beehive, your hive, and ain't nothing in there but an echo and wax. Are you in the Sooner State? I'm not sure what that is. Okay. How you doing, Rebecca Jacobs? Uh-oh. Kira Mommy 5 said, what? Yeah. It's a trip. You learn. They ain't no different than, in a way, they just like people. The way they do stuff. You know, too many people in your house, somebody got to go. It's too many grown-ass people in one house. Okay. Okay, my name said, even if it's capped. Oh, when it's capped, when you got capped honey, it's time to extract that honey. Go watch my video and you will see those. When that honey is capped, it would have been time to take that honey out of there. Yes. Oh, when they ready to take it. Yeah, they listen. This how easy it is for them to take the honey. They put the lid on it. They capped it. It ain't nothing but wax. So when they want to eat the honey, that honey is for them. They cap it so it don't get moisture, germs, or nothing, bacteria in it. So when they're hungry, they take the lid off and they eat it, feed it to the babies, feed it to the queen. Now to feed the babies, they mix the pollen with the honey. They bring in pollen on their back legs. They bring in honey. They make the honey, bring in the nectar, make the honey. They mix the pollen with the honey, and they make a thing called bee bread. And feed, I can't make that up. It's a funny word to me. They feed the bee bread to the larvae to make new bees. So they know what they're doing. You got to look at it like this. When you got the honey super, that's their pantry. That's like you right now prepared. You got your beans and rice put up somewhere for this kind of time we're going through. That's what they're doing. They're preparing for rough times. They're always prepared for this. They've been around for millions of years. They know what they're doing. They stay prepared. That's why they work. Another lesson that us humans need to take. We need to work, stay prepared, stay stocked up for rough times. Because it might be a drought. They always think like it might not be no flowers this year. If the frost hit and kill all the flowers, what we going to do? It's okay. We got plenty of stored up. Let me see. How do you know when the frames are capped? Only by pulling and checking them. Yes. That's why I said that new stupid hive is stupid. Because you have to get in your hive and check your hives for everything. They turned that thing into a damn bubblegum machine. I hate that. I think that thing is pure, uncut evil. Stupid. They make people believe that you'll never have a bee touch you. You don't have to wear a suit. You don't have to do nothing. You just crank this little handle and squeeze some honey out into a jar. You will see that commercial. That's some bullshit. And every single person that I did research and found several people that I used to respect, using that thing that even had me like, hey, maybe it does work. They were endorsed by them. And once they had to come out and say they were endorsing it, of course, you're getting paid to tell people this stupid shit worked. You have to, this is not a shortcut kind of thing. It's just not one of those things. Good night, Stephen Lewis. Oh, no. Said night, Sandra. Night, Sandra. Okay, let me get off here. Y'all been on here for hours. This video is long as hell. I just felt like hanging out with y'all. And I love the questions. I love the questions because you know how I feel about bees. You have to leave bees honey. Yes, you do. I never take more than 1/3 to 50%. 50% is pushing it. But I leave like 1/3 in there. I take 1/3. Leave them they honey. You don't even know what 1/3 is. All that honey that I be taking, that's like 1/3 to a half. Half every blue moon. That's like, trust me, that's more than enough honey. You ain't gonna know what to do when you got about 6 5-gallon buckets full of honey. You think it's not, it don't sound like much, but when you looking at 6 5-gallon buckets of honey, you gotta keep buying these jars because I think 1 5-gallon bucket, I think it fills up like 3 pack of these 12 ounces. Something I can't quite remember. That's a lot of money. And don't try to skimp. That's why I wanted. Look, I had ran out of them jars. That's how this ended up in here. Because I ran out of jars one day. I had to get that honey out. And I took the candy out of this jar that my mama gave me years ago. I took the candy out, washed it out, sterilized it, dried it out, and poured all the rest of the honey in here. And this is where it's been ever since. It's even better use than honey. Than candy. Did you plant your potatoes? Nope. They still growing. I have more sweet potatoes now slips. You won't even believe it if I showed you down in this corner. Off of this one potato. Look, it's still pumping out babies. I still got, they ready to go straight in the ground now. I don't got to put them in the cup. But I got a cup down here. I got these cups. It'll blow your mind. Y'all saw how many I had the other day. Let me see. Let me see if I can see it down there. Oh, I'm tangled up on other stuff. Oh, you can't see. There you go. All of them sweet potatoes. And there's some on the front porch. That's about 20 of them right there. Told you, keep making your slips. Don't waste your potato. Just keep pulling them off like this. Don't waste your whole potato. People waste their potato and go to plant the whole potato. I used to do that. I don't do that no more. See that got roots on it? Pluck that off. Pull that sucker right off of there. Now I still got my potato. It's still producing more plants, and I got a new plant. Put that in some dirt and or go put it straight outside if it's warm enough. If it's not warm enough, go put this in a cup of soil and let it keep growing. If you don't got a cup of soil, put it in a cup of water. Just like that. Don't waste your potatoes. You get way more slips this way. Okay. Let me see. More income. More income. Right now, I got enough to plant and sell. How long did it take to make the slips? They start really pumping out, I'm going to say about 30 days. And these are some is these the Asian purple sweet potatoes or the African sweet potato? I can't remember which ones they were. But I got them from an Asian store, and they were so delicious. I just wanted the slips off of them, and there you go. If you try to buy that crap online, they going to break your pockets. Or they going to rip your whole pocket off. Trust me, not just shipping. The price of one slip that I just, look, what I just showed you right here, if it live on the travel to your house, they gonna ask, oh, we gotta have $20 for that. You see what I just did? I just plucked that off a potato and throw it in a cup of water for free. And I literally got about 50 slips. I know I definitely got about 20 in the house and I got another 20 or more outside. So don't waste your money. Leb, my Fuyu persimmon tree is coming back alive. How's your tree? All of them coming alive. Even Norby. I pinched Norby. He green. He's still shy. But he doing all right. Bonita woke. Rasputia, you know her mean ass woke. All of them coming to life. Little Claude, you out there woke. Leb, off subject. I bought an apple tree after watching your video. Let me see. I started researching and I'm hearing I need a pollinator. Is that true? What can I do? What kind of apple tree did you buy? It depends on what kind of apple tree you got. Because I got a couple of shortcuts for you. I know, I'm rooting for Norman. He's still buck naked. But She got a Granny Smith. I got a Granny Smith waking up. Good night, Angela's Garden Sense. It was, thank you for coming in, hanging out with us. I just felt like talking. This ain't even one of those videos. I just felt like having a good time. That's all. Toby Gads, and I needed to answer a lot of questions that y'all been asking me. So this was the night for that. I taught my 6-year-old how to do it. Thanks to you. Thank you so much. We call it clipping and dipping. There you go. I like that. Clipping and dipping. That sounds gangster as hell. Bees, what about those horizontal hives? That is called an African top bar hive. That's the one earlier in the video I was talking about I made from scratch. You can't buy them nowhere. You got to make that. And it's simple as hell. You can make a top bar hive in about an hour, if that, with some half-ass tools. The reason it's called the top bar hive, the African top bar hive, because over in Africa, they make those so they can get honey from the bees out of, they just carve out a log and put sticks across it. You know, the log is like in a U-shape, and they put sticks across it. When the bees go in, they just make comb and honey off those sticks. And they pick that stick up, and it's full of honey. You'll go in the videos of my beekeeping, you'll see me doing that in top bar hive. You can't buy those, you gotta make those. Because that's kind of a third world country kind of, I ain't saying Africa is a third world country. I'm saying in places that are not, their income is low and they're really doing it to survive, for real, in those parts of the world. That's where it comes from. It's a lesson for if you don't got no money, you don't got no means, but you got to survive. What's the first thing they thought about making to survive? Honey. And it's that easy. A carved out log and some sticks. That's what they did. Question, how often do I fertilize my vegetable garden? Collards, kale, mustard, arugula. It depends on what kind of fertilizer you use. It depends on how big your garden bed is. It depends on if you got it in a container. It depends on if you got it in the ground. It depends on how close together you got them. It's so many variables to that. I don't even want to entertain you with a wrong answer. It's so much more information I need before I would answer that. I don't want to steer you down the wrong path. Carved out log and some sticks. Okay, how do I lure the bees? Go back early, first thing in this video, and I just showed you. Get some old wax. Old beehive wax from a beekeeper or something. And rub that wax inside of a cardboard box. Put it on a tree line next to water. Bees will start checking it out. And before you know it, do this for everybody. Do me a favor. Go on YouTube. Like I said, I'm not the god of beekeeping. Go on YouTube and look at how to catch a swarm. How to catch a honeybee swarm. You're going to see hundreds of videos of people doing everything I just said. Using some of the craziest stuff. You might even see me. Hey, Ronnie, Virginia, how you doing? So just do that for, you know, let me see. Oh my God, hubby and I love you and lady there. Thank you so much. Who is the A&K family? Thank you so much. So I want to try your wine. Ooh, I want you to make it so you can taste it. It's the same stuff. Good looking out, family. Anytime, Troy Jenkins. Thank you. Let me see, who is this? Where's my little old man glasses? Irritated. Good evening, Mr. Led. Why my container cabbage turn yellow, but the ones outside are healthier? I don't know. I can't answer. I don't know where you are. I don't know what kind of container you use. I don't know how often you water it. See, I'm going to tell you this. Real quick. No matter, I'm going to answer that urine question in a minute too. No matter where you live, is one problem that I keep seeing in the emails. I water it every day. I water it every other day. I water it twice a day. I water it twice every other day. Let me tell you something. Everybody get too happy with the watering holes. You do not have to water your... The day I did that video, it was raining so much, you got to account for the weather. If it's going to rain today, don't water it today. That's why I like my neighbors. Their grass gets watered whether it's raining or not. They sprinklers come on whether it's raining or not. And I look over there like, boy, is they slow? It's pouring. It's flood. But they sprinklers will come up in the flood and go to sprinkling. You got to use your head. If it's going to rain today, don't water it. They don't need water every single day. When you're dealing with cabbage, you're dealing with lettuce, kale, you're going to kind of see them wilt a little bit. Don't panic. When you see that stuff, collard greens, red mustard greens, cabbage, kale, when you see it wilt like that as soon as the sun come out. The sun rays make the leaves kind of wilt a little bit. But soon as the sun about to go down, that cabbage, that kale, everything will stand right back up. And look like right now, if I showed you the cabbage, it looked like a hell of a cabbage. But when I did that video the other day, you saw my leaves wilt. Because it was like I was coming straight home from work. You know, it's 3 o'clock, sun up high. It's hot. So everything kind of looked like, help me. Don't panic and go to watering it. Don't water. This is what I do. I let my soil kind of dry out a little bit before I even think about watering it. Even in that little container. They don't need that every 5 minutes. You'll kill them. So when your leaves is turning yellow like that, you overwatering it. You're killing it. Drowning it. When it's dying, like when you drying it too much, you ain't watering it enough, the leaves just kind of start falling off. They really don't even turn yellow. They just kind of start falling off. That'll let you know you ain't giving it enough water. But if it's turning yellow, you overwatering that sucker. I need that information. I've been water happy. Yeah, I know this gardening stuff is fun. It is. See? But just like the bees, you don't have to help once nature start going. It's like you got a kid on a bicycle with training wheels off, right? And you go, okay, keep pedaling. That's you at first when you plant the seeds. Keep pedaling. The baby still riding the bike. Think you still got your hand on the seat and the steering wheel, right? On the handlebar. No, that's when you kind of let them go. Back off once you see that gardener took root and it's doing good. You just stand back and you just say, keep pedaling. Stop watering. Take the training wheels off. Stand back. And every right when you see the baby hit the brake. Water. I know this is fun, but having too much fun, you can kill your plant by drowning it. Okay? Don't need all that. My garden, I told y'all year after year, my garden is kind of like a hands-free garden. I let Mother Nature do it. I ain't got time to be standing there watering like I'm retired because I ain't. Only give it what it need when it need it. Don't spoil it like a college kid. Don't spoil a kid. Make the kid beg a little bit. Please, Dad, please get me this card. Man, I'll cut the grass all summer. That's what you do to your garden. Don't just keep feeding it, because then you're going to have a big, fat-ass, unhealthy-ass baby, right? Like your pet. Stop feeding that. I deliver dog food all the time. I keep feeding that big, fat-ass dog. I go deliver something to somebody's house, and every time they got this 50-pound bag of dog food, I got to break my back, deliver that up to the house. And you know who looking out the window? Big, fat-ass dog. He don't even got a real bark. I don't know if the dog is barking or he in pain. Oh, shit. Same thing with your garden. Don't keep feeding it. It don't need all that bullshit. You got to let nature do her thing. All your job was to do was guide it along and make sure it can pedal. Keep pedaling. Run with the bike. And then back off. Keep your eye on it. You know it's still in the street. But keep your eye on it. That's all. But don't keep training wheels on. That your job is over. You planted the seed. The plant is in the soil. It's growing strong. Back off. Okay? I know this is crazy. I don't know why I keep thinking about my own kids when I think about the garden and everything else. I think about my own kids. But it all relates. It's all the same thing. The bees, the garden, and the dog with training your kids. It's the same stuff. You can't keep spoiling it all, or it's going to depend on you too much and be fat and greedy and unhealthy. Big fat dog. So, okay, I'm sorry. I'm having problems with peach leaf curl, and my peach is not getting big. I pruned them and sprayed them with a solution that has neem oil. That's exactly what. Leave that peach alone. Your peach is probably, leaves are curling, is probably because you overwatered it. Peach leaves curl when you overwater it. When it's soaking in water, those leaves curl up like that. Your peaches ain't getting big because you ain't giving. It's only, it's what is it? It's not even April yet. It's not time for you to be picking no peaches. I got peaches and I've had this tree in the ground for 4 years and the peaches look like gumballs. It's not time. You got to be patient. Take it easy. I know this is fun, but this is the part where you get to sit back and be proud of what you done. Staying up all night with your kid, teaching them the math problems. That part is over. Now you get to sit back and watch your kid get married, a good job, graduate from college, get a degree. That's your garden. You get to now kind of sit back and watch the fruits of your labor grow and say, I did that. Every blue moon, I don't care how grown your kid is. Dad, I need like $50. They done towed my car. Boy, what you done did? Why you waking me up? Huh? I need to get down there. Take my keys and leave me the hell alone. Same thing in the garden. Sit back. Every blue moon, you got to get up and do something. Damn, bird done pecked my peaches. Every blue moon, your babies wake you up for something stupid. But that's right there. The training wheels is off. Okay, this is the time to enjoy this because when it start getting hot and have your ass out there running every 5 minutes, watering, and then soapy solutions for cabbage worms and all kind of other alienated shit from outer space eating your stuff, that's when you start pouncing. But right now is the time that this is the quiet before the storm, okay? Stuff is growing, stuff is pretty, everything is green. It's time. Because it's about to start popping, okay? You know it. Everybody that be gardening, been gardening for years, know it's about to start going on. The heat is coming, and them cabbage worms from outer space is coming. You're going to see some bugs that ain't in no book that you know of. You're going to be trying to ask everybody, I got this beetle. It's even eating the seed of the peach. I don't know. I ain't never seen no bug like that. What bug is this? Everybody going to be like, I don't know. It's eating the seed? It got teeth. Oh, no. Cut that whole tree off. Cut the whole tree down. Shit. Throw that tree away. Depends on how long it takes to get established. It's not system. Right. Right. A little and be patient. Right. That's the key. You got to be patient. Especially if your tree is bare root versus a already potted, established tree. All of that factors in. So giving you one answer for all of those different problems, I would never do that to you. That's why some people ask me questions on there, and I can never just say, all you do is just do this to it. It ain't that simple. Excuse me. Once you start gardening and get the feel of it, because you got to start before you can get the feel of it. Once you get the feel of it, you start realizing, okay, maybe that worked for lead. But for some reason, when I do this, it works for me. That's how you find out. Everything don't work for everybody everywhere. Then you start coming up with your own solutions, your own little magical potions that you share with us, and that what create the community. Because you share your secret garden tips with us. And we love it. We love it. All of that is for all of us. That's knowledge just spreads and keeps going. Rose 5150 taught me how to do cuttings. I can't count how many people that I've taught how to do cuttings. All from learning from her. See, that knowledge is going to spread like a forest fire. No offense, California. But it's going to spread like a forest fire. All because one sweet little lady took 5 minutes and said, baby, you ain't doing that right. And everybody to think I know everything, I don't. And I take your criticism quick. So what am I doing? You got too much dirt. Too much dirt, Led. You got to add more perlite to that. That's why you've been failing. No. Perlite? Perlite. I did that shit and had 100% sex. Not sex rate.
I'm thinking about that.
100% success rate, not sex rate. 100% success rate every year since. It's been working. Okay, I have Juddish 3. So I have a vine, Allie. You inspired me with your citrus, Allie. Good. Thank you so much. Green Organic Love said, leave us and our fires alone. I remember you was dealing with that for a minute. I said, no offense. I'm sorry, Green Organic Love. You know y'all is always on fire. Always. Woo, every time I see California, y'all hot. Kudos to all the postal workers, doctors, nurses, first responders, etc. You rock. God bless you all and stay safe out there. Thank you very much. Because we deal with a lot of crazy stuff out there. Yes, thank you. Good night, Rosalind. I'm about to go to bed too, because I got to get up and do it all over again in the morning. I'm just having too much damn fun. I'm having so much fun, I almost want to call off. But now I can't call off because I just said I want to call off on the computer and some of the people at work is watching me. Yep. Screwed that up, didn't I? So Carter's Eat say, yes, thank you, Postman, when we see you. Thank you. Thank a Postman when you see him. Thank you. I just screwed up talking too much. I could have had an extra day off. Screwed that up quick. I can't call off. Heather, I wish I could. Nah, I done messed it up. Because now I'm going to be like, I don't feel well. You don't feel well because you was drinking liquid lead talking about bees all night? I'm on my way. So, yeah, I screwed it up. Oh, urine. Before I go, it's my allergies. I'm not sick. I didn't get bit. It's like The Walking Dead right now. You hear somebody say, achoo. He got bit. He can't come into camp. He got bit. No, I didn't get bit. Okay, they didn't get me. You know, I was fighting them off. I didn't get bit, okay? I got allergies, seasonal allergies. Honestly, I wouldn't be around my family and risking my family's life if I was infected right now. Knowingly infected. But I didn't get bit. You know, every time somebody be fighting that zombie, they whooping ass, but this one sneak up behind them and be like, oh! They didn't get me. Don't get bit right now. Don't get bit. I had somebody too. Every day this happened. I know y'all go through it too. Every day somebody wanna give you a high five, fist bump you, hit the rock every day. And I'd be like, Corona, I think if I make them laugh, some people be like, seriously? I'd be like, yeah, seriously. I think if you laugh at it, it's less offensive. I've seen people say, I ain't touching you, coronavirus. That's offensive. But if you just hit them with, they be like, oh, my man, Corona. No, I'm not, no. You know, people is dying because of this. I think we need to put this back in order right here. So, I know it's kind of played out a little bit, but we need to put that back on the mainstream right here. Do some Star Trek shit, Wakta, something got to, something. Seem like all of those signs I just did is from black folks. All of the ways we say what's up or greet each other, it really ain't got nothing to do with touching one another, do it. It's always just like, one love, my man. It's, maybe we need to all get back into that. You know, my husband works for Amazon and he ain't fist bumping, elbow tapping nobody. Me either. And the people, to me, that gets, thank you, Ms. Kraft. The people that gets offended, you ain't taking this seriously enough to me. So I don't care if you get offended. This is killing people. I could see if this was something else. People are dying. People are dying for fist bumping. I don't owe nobody that much doubt. Chest bumping, none of that shit. To die for it? The risk? Come on, people. It cures chill blades. I missed something. Thank you so much, Crest, for let me go to bed. I could talk all night tonight. I feel so good and I love talking to y'all, but I want to show y'all something. I'm a blow her spot up. I'm blow her spot up real quick. Oh, I can't. Because I was going to show her text, but I can't. If I show you this one, you will see the rest. So I'm not going to show that. Anyway, Lady Led told me to shh. If she can hear me that far on that wing of the house, then I am cutting up. So, okay. Good night, everybody. Urine. Thank you. Trash. Urine. Yes, before I go, that's the last thing I'm going to talk about. Yes, I use urine around my plants, around my chicken coop, around my garden, because everybody in the world on the planet keeps saying, why does your cabbage, kale, and greens look good? Why aren't bugs on your stuff? That's not real. Trust me, I got a lot of people saying my stuff ain't real. They think it's plastic, and I got it from what's one of them craft stores. And planted a bouquet of flowers in the soil. Urine. Disgusting, but effective. Urine. Not mine. Urine. Urine. Literally, really, seriously. What I use on my cabbage and all that stuff, if I do see any signs of a cabbage worm, soapy water in a spray bottle. Might put a little urine in it. You should be washing your greens and stuff off before you eat it. You do know that anyway. People are like, ugh, you spray it on you. Yeah. It's mine, not urine. I'm sorry, that's so corny. I'm sorry. But yeah. Wash your greens and your lettuce and stuff off before you eat it anyway. But see, this what gets me. Some of the people I done told on email, I use urine to keep away pests, animals, and everything else. Ugh, that's gross. Ugh. You will say, ugh, gross, yuck, to urine, your urine. But you won't say yuck to pesticides, poison, stuff to say, it'll make you blind in one eye if it touch your fingertip. It's known to give birth defects, cause cancer. One leg might fall off when you start playing hopscotch. You'll spray that shit on your plant without even caring. It just literally told you it's going to kill you. It said, in layman's terms, you good as dead. Your ass is good as dead. You use this. They told you. And you ignored that because they used a bunch of big fancy words to explain it. But you don't like me because I use urine. My urine. This natural. And it's fertilizer. And it rinses off. Yours go in your bloodstream from the store out of black bottles and give you cancer. So, just saying. Use your head. You know, I thought about something today, and Lady Liz said, don't say that, that's me. Somebody was kind of being a little derogatory to me, so I was going to be back. You know how I get childish. And she said, don't do that. I said, okay, I won't. But I am going to say what I was going to say to the person, which was, you know the old saying, think before you speak. Now it's kind of think before you type. People thumbs move and they be asleep. You ever seen this on one of your kids? Now this is kind of a real thing. Before people, you know how I say, ooh, what I put my foot in my mouth. Now you put your thumb in your mouth because your thumb's going to move into saying dumb shit. You didn't think this through. You know what I'm saying? And you didn't think about who you was talking to. You didn't think about the repercussions of typing this stupid shit either. People need to watch more of The First 48. The First 48, the TV show about murders. You know what happened on most of those murders and why they got killed or why somebody got hurt, somebody lost a baby? Because somebody's stupid ass thumbs got to twinkling. You said the wrong shit to the wrong person, and the wrong person wanted to give you the right solution. Sometimes people, now it ain't your mouth, because we don't speak to one another anymore. We social distancing, number one. But even before this disease and social distancing, we started losing communication and losing humanity from our technology. Now, your thumbs can get your ass hurt or killed. Mind your thumbs, because they seem like they got a mind of their own nowadays. Kids too. Kids go to doing this and sexting and take a picture of the cooter. Cooter, balls, titties, that's on there forever. Your thumbs did that. You didn't even think about, oh my God, my teacher might see it, my husband might see it, I might be president someday. You ain't even thinking. Your thumbs, you letting your thumbs do, you giving your thumbs too much power. One of the ugliest pieces on your whole body, you giving it too much power. So sometime in the comment section, and this goes for everybody on the internet, on the YouTube, everything, man, calm your thumbs down. Sometimes do this here. Remember this old trick that your gym teacher did, this shit here. Watch this, got your thumb. Ha ha, remember that shit, that old trick? Used to scare the shit out of me. My gym teacher's name was Mr. Padlock, I remember that. And I couldn't understand how he could put his thumb back on. But that's what we really need to do right now. Calm your damn thumbs down for somebody come and handle that. That some of that stuff is our kids too. You know, don't keep letting your kids take pictures of their junk and put on the damn thing. On YouTube and stuff. We out of control. In a way, I'm going to say this. The way we've been treating the world, pollution, hatred, I'm going to say this, then I'm going to get off. I'm surprised this all we got so far is the coronavirus. It's horrible. But as horrible as we've been to the earth, the thing that keeps us alive, the thing that we're made from, It's horrible. That's like you raising your child and then your child get grown and punch you in the mouth. That's the earth. As horrible as we treated the earth. Just like a child. Child punch you in the mouth. Then he go to prison. First person he called, the first person he called is you.
Can you get me out of jail? I was at the club and I got in the fight.
Forgot he punched you in the mouth. You the mama, you the daddy. What you do? Yeah, I'm gonna help you this time. You gotta get yourself together. That's the earth. Earth is to say we done destroyed the earth. We done ruined it. And so far, all we getting is a good ass whooping. And we grounded in the house. You on punishment till further notice. The world is telling us, just like a parent, if you keep this shit up, what your mama never said, somebody gonna mess around and kill you, you keep this shit up. I'm gonna mess around with your ass. The world is warning us, this is bad, but this is just a warning compared to what the earth really could do to us. That's why I preach, recycle, recycle, recycle. If the world wanted us finished, the world is kind of like a parent right now. It's like, look, I ain't gonna keep on telling you, Willie. You come out them streets, clean up your act. That's the world telling us right now. This shit is killing. It's us getting a whooping, and now we're on punishment. Stuck in the house, looking outside. What is our guards out there saying? Can you come out and play? No. I'm on punishment. How long? I don't know. I guess until I straighten up my act. That's what they said anyway. That's us. We look. That's how stupid we look. Looking out the window at our guards. We can't touch our friends. We can't go out and be with our friends. Can't go hang out with our friends. We on punishment. People is dying. That's our ass whooping. People is getting sick. That's our ass whooping. And now we stuck in the house. If we don't change, this is a warning. If we don't change the shit we doing to this earth, like you said, you gonna mess around and get yourself killed out in the streets, Willie. You keep on talking like that, you gonna talk to the wrong person. The wrong person gonna give you the right deal. So, that's it, y'all. I'm ready. I'm so talkative tonight. It's just this damn poison in me. Thank you, guys. I'm sorry for babbling on. Y'all know how I get. So, everybody, please be careful, stay safe, be smart. I love you, and I'm out. Please have a wonderful night. Sorry this video was so long, but I was having a good time. So, good night, everybody, and thank you for hanging out. I can't believe this many people hung out with me for hours. Thank you. Guava to everybody. One more shot. Guava, everybody. Good night. I'm going to do a video, short, fairly short, step by step on how to bait this hive. I want you to start helping me keep some bees. Everybody, even if you try, because the best thing I got, the best feeling I got is somebody actually saying, okay, I caught them. What do I do now? That gets me excited. Oh, what do you mean you caught them? They in the box. They in the box? Yeah. We go from there. Everybody have a wonderful night. Okay? Guava. I love you. Good night. Miss Kraft. Guava, everybody. Good night.